Start it twice. Start it.
Lights come on. Hey, this is the day, skate, bro. They love it.
I mean, I hey. I can't see nobody checking in anymore. Why does Facebook do that for me? Oh, I like this part right here. It's that wavy part. It's like, hey, okay.
That part
you're waiting for to come back.
Yeah. Just put two times. This is the demo track.
Don't do it again. Flipping and love this part.
Hey. There's nothing better than the
phone call. That is true. God. I can get it.
Yow.
We sharing, we liking, we getting ready, getting hyped.
Press the shit button. Body press the shit button.
Okay.
Press the share button.
Yeah.
Everybody press the share button. Press the share button. Everybody press the share button. You got the same color shirt on? You teeled in the mug. And you just green.
Money green.
Yeah, what's good? What it look like? What it
is?
Talk to me.
Yeah,
everybody
man.
Hit.
Yeah.
I like the thumbs and the loves. I like that. Let's make it a
appreciate
thing.
Appreciate y'all,
let's make
man.
Make it a vibe. Everybody press the like
here.
And share button
we
one
here,
time.
We here.
Feel
we
me?
Here.
Like and share button
like
and one.
Share. Like them numbers,
time.
Man. I like them.
You dig?
What's up, Maria?
You dig?
What's happening? Ann Brown on the check in.
You dig?
Shakira on the check in.
You dig?
Kimberly on the check in.
You dig?
Barry Bummers on the check in.
You dig?
My man John Conton in the building. What's good, bro? You know what I'm saying?
All that.
Today is a good day.
Is it? Today was a fucking shitty day.
What up, Kathy?
Well, no. Today is a good day for us.
Oh.
Relax. it's a good day for us.
Nah. We're going to get to that.
Yeah, we'll get to that. But it's a good day
good
for us.
Fucking day.
I can see everything. Okay.
Because I noticed these shirts y'all wearing. I noticed.
He could not
just,
wait.
What is that?
These shirts are just.
I just happened to notice this. Like,
y'all both corny. I don't know that y'all bad.
What does that shirt say?
I can't read. What?
I think that's a. That's it. The podcast killer?
Oh, no. You want to stand up?
You want to stand up and show the.
You want him to model?
Y'all
done asked the wrong nigga.
I ain't got no music. Right, you gotta walk without music.
Oh my god. Y'all done asked the wrong
nigga. We should have prepared for that. So let me see that shirt. If you look.
You are now looking at Jay Willa with the ensemble of the teal.
Of the teal.
And it says
the podcast killer, aka Podcast Poppy.
And aka the Podfather.
Yeah.
So shout out to Jay Willa modeling
Jay
the Willa Wednesday's
right.
tea.
That's nice. All right. Yeah. Sit your punk ass down. What about you, Barry? What you wearing, man?
My shit just says it's a
can we can
shirt.
We see it?
You gotta model that shit.
You gotta model it, bro. Yeah. You been hitting the gym for 2 days. You might as well.
two and a half days,
bro.
You ain't shit.
Come on,
let me see.
And you can get all sizes. As you see,
look
Barry,
at that. Right? Look at his pecs sticking out and shit.
Yeah, Barry got the medium.
You got titties.
You got titties.
Fresh worked out titties.
Come on, titties.
All right.
Big titty.
I guess I'll go next.
What you doing?
Because I'm happy.
You gonna stand up?
I'm gonna stand up.
Just don't put your arm up.
I see, man.
Don't do that.
Keep your arms
already?
Down.
Already, bro.
Teal was
why nobody tell me that?
Teal gonna tell. Okay?
At least
stand
I'm,
up.
At least
Let me
I'm
see.
Sure.
Let
I'm
me see.
Not unsure.
Let me see. Let me see. Okay, what'd I say? Damo never been a lame-o. Okay.
You sure say your name.
Facts.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah.
You know, I try to.
Yo, where you got that shirt from?
Hey, man.
from the Willow Wednesday website, I think. Is that
the what?
Oh, fuck that up. I say the Willow Wednesday website is where
we got a website.
We got a website, man. So
wait, we do got a website.
So yeah, shout out to the website the bar just found out about today. Well, we will have all the merch for everybody, t-shirts, mugs, all kind of stuff, man.
Oh, it's goody, Pat.
You'll be able to get the links to the sponsors and the sponsorship, man. And we coming up, man. And it's thanks to y'all, man. Shout out to the family. Shout out to everybody that rocks out with us, man, every week. And yeah.
I mean, hot. Just all that modeling.
That. Yeah, I'm hot too.
I'm slide over.
A little warm in there.
All that modeling got me hot because I'm just hot.
Also, real quick, shout out to Mama Wade. It's her birthday.
Oh, it's a fact.
Shout out to Mama Wade.
Shout out to Mama Wade. Happy birthday, Mama Wade.
Big things are going on.
Wade is doing that. He's doing the family thing. Shout out to that.
Cool.
You feel me? So he called out of work today. You feel me?
All right.
Well deserved.
We going to write him up.
Imagine.
He gets a write up.
Imagine
that. How was y'all week, though, man? Talk to me.
Shit. Week was actually, it was all right, man, other than the sad stuff that's going on right now. But my week was pretty good. My leg is getting better, so that's cool. I was happy to get these t-shirts and be here, man. What about you?
How was your week, man?
It was tiring.
Okay.
But you know, Wednesday is my Friday.
Mm. Okay.
I tell that to y'all all the time, so shout out to Wednesday.
Because it's a Wednesday thing.
It's a Wednesday thing.
Uh-huh.
See? Come on now. Mm-hmm. The alley.
You know what I mean?
You seen it. You see I that? Threw it on the
back. I understand. You know, we out here selling our merch.
Shout out to Allen on the check-in. What's good, brother? How you feeling?
What's happening?
Yo, brother.
What about
Josh.
You, sir? Josh.
Ask Josh, then we go back to Willa. Don't give a shit what he got to say.
How was your week, brethren?
Well, I was coming off another booked and busy week.
Okay,
nice.
Bag talk.
But you know what? The best part of my week was actually just not doing a fucking thing.
That makes sense.
For a few days.
Amen.
I needed to replenish badly.
Just sit in the crib.
Badly. That's it. I was just in the crib. I didn't go. Itching. I didn't go nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
I
didn't scratch.
Bro, it was wonderful. It was wonderful. And I looked around and I was just like, I got a dope crib.
I like my house. My house is dope.
Nah, we lit, man.
Okay. Right. Okay.
Sound good, man. What about you, sir?
My week was fire, man. My week was all right. Some up, some down, some good, some bad. But other than that, I'm here.
Okay.
Some fuck shit happened earlier. We're going to talk about it.
You made it through.
I went top golfing.
Yeah, what was that?
That shit is fun as hell.
What was that?
It's out in Jersey.
Oh, you went top golf?
I went to top golf.
That shit is fun.
What is it, just fun? Golf?
It's a driving range.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But you can knock the ball into like these little holes and you get points.
I heard that's where rich people go.
For real?
Play golf.
Damn, you rich, bro?
Yeah, so I was broken in the motherfucker because I ordered shit.
They got money, yo.
Shit me.
Hey, man.
Nah, but top golf is dope.
Okay.
That shit was fun.
Now you get a Groupon. You know what I'm saying?
You feel what I'm saying? Groupon. Hello.
That's it. You got to think.
You got to shop on a budget.
You know me. I don't do nothing expensive.
Groupon, nigga, motherfucker.
That's true.
Oh, it was baby Jaylee's half birthday.
You feel what I'm saying? My daughter turned 6 months and all that.
Six months.
I didn't know people do that, but
it's a thing. It's a thing, man. It's a thing.
Okay.
You celebrate the half.
To me, people be bugging out with like 7, 8, not you know, them weird months. Like your baby 2.5 months old.
No, I hate when people like, oh yeah, my child's 36 months. Like, what the fuck is that mean?
Too much math.
That's too much math.
But people do that.
I don't. Yeah.
Like people do that.
Three. Yeah.
So your baby's 3. No, 36.
Like, oh yeah, she's 29 months. What?
Yeah. You'd be like,
now you got to sit there and do calculus. You're like, what? Carry the 1, then 3. Like I dropped out of school.
Facts.
Nah, but mother, stop doing that.
Yeah, man.
Mother,
stop.
Do that stupid.
You stress
shit.
Out everybody.
That
else.
Shit is dumb.
But shout out, baby Jaylee, my girl.
Yeah, man.
That's a fact.
What up, Aisha?
Look, Salida said top golf is my jam. Yo, top golf is fire.
Hey, man.
We gotta do that.
We gotta go.
I did miniature golfing one time.
Mini golf is
hard
dope.
Hard as shit.
Can you do groups?
Hell yeah. I'm both groups of 6 because of the whole COVID
that's
shit.
What I was wondering.
So there's 6 people
like,
in the
maybe
bay.
Maybe we can have a Willow Wednesday top golf.
We can get multiple bays next to each other.
Okay.
You can. It's like a bowling alley. You can get a bunch of lanes.
Okay.
It'll
only
be
thing
dope.
I noticed, y'all had mad food.
Mm. Yeah, y'all had mad nachos and tortillas. Nigga.
Yeah, we was out there.
It was hella tortillas.
We was out there. Like it was
wait,
a vibe.
Was there mozzarella sticks?
There was no mozzarella sticks.
Oh, they could sell my dick.
There was no mozzarella sticks
worst,
at all.
Man.
No mozzarella sticks.
This dude ordered mozzarella and fucking chicken. What is it? Chicken fingers everywhere.
But everywhere. He be in Greece.
I remember one time we was.
He's in Santorini.
I
like, let me get the chicken fingers and the French fries.
And then be mad.
I hate people like that.
And then be mad.
It's not like Brooklyn.
It don't taste like Brooklyn.
I don't like this shit.
I remember one time we was in, what was he, in D.C.? And I said, what's your burrito look like? And the man told me the whole burrito. I said, cool, give me a quesadilla.
I do remember.
I remember that shit.
I do remember.
He explained every intricacy of this burrito.
Even which type of bean it is.
It's lightly, it's a light flour tortilla chip. Slightly roasted with honey basil. And he's like, all right, cool, let me get a quesadilla.
I'm not gonna lie, the story's getting me tight. You know?
I hate people
yo,
like that.
Them two, like, wanted to fight me for the waiter. Because like, it was mad funny.
We all had to wait through that description, too.
Facts. And he did his job. Like he described the burrito to a T. You knew what you was gonna get.
It probably sounded amazing.
It did.
It did.
He's like, oh yeah, that's dope. That's dope. Let me get a let me get a quesadilla. Let me get a quesadilla. Because all that bullshit you're talking about, I want to hear.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's crazy. All right.
Press the drop. Let's get the goddamn show going.
Let's do it.
Oh, the biggest pool.
This is a game old track.
Y'all can't stop it that way.
Straight up.
Get in it out.
What's good? I go by the name.
That was so cheesy. Oh my god.
Damo, never been a lame-o.
I was like, he better say his name.
I was going to say that goddamn name. I definitely thought about not saying it. I was like,
it's your boy, that boy, Barry.
This is Jay Willa, the podcast killer, a.k.a. Podcast Poppy, a.k.a. the Pie Father, and you watching Willa Wednesdays, where you about to get some ghetto news
from your relationship gurus, motherfucker.
Hold that. You can't knock me, but you can't move me from the microphone, though. I still got to say the part.
You
push me from the microphone. I can't speak.
Hold that.
Fuck you.
Oh, man, because he ain't want to bring a shirt.
You feel what I'm trying to say?
How I ain't want to bring a shirt, but you got a shirt on.
Mediator, moderator, roll call, selective stitching, temporary lover, highly toxic, can't remember shit, only got one job, head ass, Bari.
And can't do that. And before we get into that,
you know what?
Let's talk about our sponsors.
I just want you to both y'all know, let y'all ever, like, trip up some stairs or some shit.
I just did. Broke my whole damn knee off.
He ain't got no kneecaps. Knees are gone.
I mean, they think calves and thighs. Like 100 years old. Shit.
All right, so
you lost them in 45. So.
Yeah, his kneecaps been gone.
Our show today is brought to you by our number one sponsor, and our number two sponsor, Lifted Teas, infused teas. They can be infused with THC, CBD, alcohol, all the above, or none of the above. They taste absolutely amazing, and they're healthy. And ours, the one that we have specifically for us, is King Pink Drip, which is the shit. So make sure you holler at us, inbox, whatever. We will put links, website, and all that to get it cracking. And that's one. The second sponsorship, I'm going to alley-oop just like that to Bari, who's searching for what he needs to say right now. Bow.
Will, you having fun over here, brother?
I'm counting condoms, cuz.
Go ahead, bro.
My phone. Just because you're toxic, filthy, and nasty doesn't mean your sex has to be.
Like that.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Because you can get it going with B Condoms.
Hey.
The first black-owned condom ever.
That's a black-owned condom company.
Yeah, man. No, this is dope. No, actually. Lit.
First things first. Oh, it is vegan
I'm
friendly.
The realist.
Yo, I said it and I said, watch this. That's what the guy said. I said, watch this. But they're vegan friendly. So no animals were killed in the process of making these condoms.
Mm.
Secondly, they're all natural for all the Nubian queens and princes.
Hmm.
Lastly, they are slightly larger than a generic condom for all the black brothers like me. Feel me? Come on now. I think you need to do that one more time for me.
Yeah, I think it cut off because even though you're lying.
Yeah,
all right,
you know the bullshit.
The computer was like, nah.
All right, y'all are salty today. Oh my God.
Listen, man, talk about the goddamn condoms, man.
But yeah, shout out to B Condoms. If you want to get a promo code on Willa Wednesdays, type in WWS20, you get 20% off on B Condoms.
Okay.
I will say that these boxes were open. Have you used some?
Speaking of, wasn't you celibate not too long ago?
And that was fried.
Yeah, that didn't last.
The box was open. Did you use some?
Yes, I used one.
Hey, now, Bobby used a sponsor. Wait a minute. Okay, so talk about
it.
How did the condom hold up?
I used the black box.
Just the black box right there?
Come on now.
Oh, and so you think you got the XL, Johnson? Heard it. You got the extra long.
So this is
long.
10 premium extra long.
Will Chamberlain, you feel me?
Will, oh, heard it.
Come on now.
Made in Thailand.
They are actually, they actually, first off, they do, they really don't smell like latex.
Okay. Like, okay. That's, no, that's lit.
So you smelt it?
But you can always smell.
I mean, I thought, okay, yeah, I'm just asking. I'm just asking.
But yeah, they don't smell like latex. That's number one. Number two, they are actually thinner.
Mm. So you get more condoms. Feeling.
They, so you felt something. Mm. You didn't feel like having a saran wrap.
Yeah, like you legit.
Like a damn garbage bag.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just, I hate that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then
how was the fit?
It was pretty snug. You know what I'm saying? It was good though.
Oh, so you say even the XL was snug?
Okay,
give me that. I see what you did there, player. The XL was snug. You heard? Okay.
Hey man, no, I support my guy.
It's dope condoms. They definitely are dope condoms. So shout out to B Condoms.
Okay.
Please use the promo code WWS20.
WWS20.
20% off on B Condoms. Support black business, man.
Listen, we out here.
Support black business. We just gonna have it spread out.
Yeah, shit. Throw the damn condom on the table.
They bet them cheap joints at the clinic give you.
Facts.
The Kings. The NYC Kings,
facts, facts, facts,
horrible.
Facts,
we're not doing that.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. But yeah, shout out to that, man.
Shout out to B Condoms, man.
What are we talking about today, man? Damn church announcements.
Hey, I'm happy to listen.
We got announcements.
Anything else?
That's it. So for now,
Josh coming out with an album,
right? Oh, also, shout out to Brooklyn Podcast Studios.
Yeah, man.
Keep them coming.
I'll have an album out soon.
If you want a studio, yes. If you want a studio to record a podcast or any
shout
audio,
the mic on the
audio, yeah. You can come to Brooklyn Podcast Studios.
Nadine,
Josh is the godfather of this shit. I'm saying, tell him Willow Wednesday sent you.
Mm-hmm.
He gonna give you the same goddamn price.
Tell him you're gonna get the same shit we pay, motherfucker.
Shit. You know what I'm saying?
So, you don't get
promo
shit.
Promo code and get nothing.
But for real, though, shout out to Josh.
It's true, though.
You feel me? Fuck it.
You just get all of my guys.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Oh, you know them too?
Oh, yes, what's up?
When you start, when you trying to start.
Facts. But shout out to Brooklyn Podcast and Studios, for real, though. So, yeah, topics.
Damn, you know what, though? I do have one more. And then
God damn it.
No, but this is, I'm excited. So y'all know the United States documentary.
Yes.
It was nominated for an Emmy.
Yes.
Did not win the Emmy.
Yes.
But I'm excited to have been part of that process. And you know what I'm saying? For all the skaters, shout out and salute to y'all, man. We made it all the way to the Emmys. And y'all seen it. It was a pretty good documentary.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I just want to salute.
Shout out to that.
That's what's up, man.
Like, shout out to that. All right.
Yeah. Shout out to
all the skaters,
that's a big fact.
Yeah, made it to the Emmys. Mm-hmm. Yeah, all right. Let's get it.
Is it selfish to not want kids?
Huh.
We were talking the other day while watching the Lakers game, and
I don't even know how that came up.
Yeah, I don't even remember.
Fuck
how
it, that's the topic. Cool.
Oh no, we were talking about Tracy
Ellis Ross.
Tracy Ellis Ross, and you stated that she said that she doesn't want kids.
Yeah.
Selfish as a motherfucker.
I forgot how the conversation went, but then somebody then said, so if you're dating her. And then she tells you that she doesn't want kids. Is that selfish? And then we said, ooh, that's a good topic.
That is.
So we're going to talk about that. Why are men conditioned to be why aren't men conditioned to be husbands the way women are conditioned to be wives?
I like that question. That was
That was in a
group.
Was
that Amira? Might have been a mirror.
Somebody
in the damn group.
Shout out to the family group, man. You fucking up.
Yeah. Go on Facebook and join the Willow Wednesday family.
It is legit
group.
Like a family. You're going to hate them. You're going to fight them, but you're going to love them all at the same
time.
It's
like fighting with your pet cousins all the time.
So, please join that. You're missing out. No justice for Breonna Taylor.
Mm.
Yeah, I said no justice.
It's all good.
They said that the police officer they charged is pretty much he got a D-class felony.
Yeah, 1 to 5 years.
Wanton endangerment.
Wow. Yeah. Not even for Brit.
We don't get into it. I don't want my blood to start boiling now. I'll wait a little bit.
Forbes insults the black community with stimulus check article.
Mm.
They fucked up big time on that too.
They said that we're supposed to be getting a second round of stimulus checks, and then the article stated that the black community will be extremely happy for that.
No, they. God
I'm
damn it, Bart.
Paraphrasing, my nigga. I didn't read it fully.
Clearly.
That wasn't it at all.
What was it then?
It was second round of stimulus packages coming. Can the black community wait?
Damn.
But I paraphrase.
All right.
What's next, Bart?
How to get money out of a man. We didn't touch on this last week.
Yeah,
but,
we supposed to hit that last week. Okay.
We're going to. What he said? What you said?
What's up, Pootie?
Pootie.
But yeah, how to get
Pootie with
out
the baby.
Yeah, shout out to Pootie. Congrats on that too, by the way.
We said congrats 3 months ago.
I didn't know. I forgot to. I thought I didn't say it, so I'm saying congratulations. Yeah, man. How you take away our congratulations?
Let's get it.
I'm squirreling your world, cuz. But I Taz said, digging the shirts. These old things.
Oh, these old question, things. Though. I got a question for y'all. What sex is better, bonnet or big T-shirt sex?
Just want to think on that for a second.
Well, I guess because I'm not really a fan of clothes, I'll say bonnet. I'm not like I take everything off.
I mean,
so I go bonnet sex for 200, Alex.
You say bonnet sex. So that's what we started?
Mm-hmm. Just real quick.
Bonnet sex or big T-shirt sex?
Bonnet sex or big T-shirt sex?
I mean, I'd say half the time they're usually together at the same time.
I know, but you got to pick one.
No, well, in my heyday, girls would be wearing a sports bra with the spandex short tight shorts or some boy shorts or something with the bonnet. So that's what I'm accustomed to seeing.
Because they all basketball players, they all come straight from the game.
Probably.
Okay.
I just see
shirt?
It. Yeah,
I like one of your shirts type.
I take the shirts off. I take clothes off.
I might go with it. I mean, if I had to choose, I'd probably go with the T-shirt.
You like big T-shirt? Yeah. Okay.
That's the
Kathy one. Said big T-shirt. Yeah. Pat said big T-shirt all the way.
Big T-shirt. Yeah, I think I'm big T-shirt. It eventually comes off.
Yeah. But I'm not
going to.
Say
so. How can you pick the shirt if it's not on?
I hear you.
The bonnet is on.
But it's like when the session gets kicked off.
What is it normally that starts?
So then I say that we amend this question because we're talking about two different things.
Okay.
If we all just agree that the shirt comes off, obviously then
it's
y'all
not
don't
about
want
the shirt, but it is
about the shirt.
I think it's
it's clearly about the shirt.
It's not, but okay.
What's it about? Is that about the shirt?
You see the person, you see the young lady in the shirt, you could be like, ooh, she wearing a big T-shirt.
I'm just laughing because like, it's clearly about the shirt. It's the shirt.
What I'm saying. Like, it could be that. It could be legit. You see the girl in a big
T-shirt. So are we talking about the moments leading up to sex or the actual sex? Because that question, the way it reads to me, is what sex is more enjoyable to you?
Over analytical motherfucker. Can you pass the
am I wrong?
It made you want to drink?
Yes.
I'm wrong
yes.
for that?
Yes.
I'm trying to understand the question so I can answer fully.
I just want to know what's better.
What's better, nigga? Shit. What sex is better? A bonnet when she got a bonnet on or she's wearing a big-ass T-shirt?
So, Bari, once again, you're talking about the moments leading up to the sex. Or are you actually talking about the sexual act?
I'm talking about when you see her, right, wearing a bonnet.
Or,
does that get you hype? Or when you see her
So we're not talking about sex. You're talking about what leads up to the sex. Let me know if I'm bugging.
I thought it was clearly about the shirt.
Am I wrong?
Son, you know what? I want to fight
him. Let me know
I
want to
fight him.
Am I wrong? If I'm wrong, I'll shut the fuck up.
We sound like the people in the family page.
I'm saying, if I'm wrong, I will shut the fuck up. Because what y'all talking, you're talking about attraction before the sex.
I want to fight.
But the question is talking about sex.
I
want
to fight.
What sex do you want more?
I
want
to fight.
I don't know.
Why would he fight me? Because I want to fight him.
I don't know.
I want to fight him.
Well, I guess if I had to pick leading up to the sex, I would leading up to the sex, I'll pick a sweatshirt.
All right, but I want to fight.
A Montclair. How about that? I want a Montclair. You pull up on a Huffy? I want a Huffy bike, too. What else you got?
Metro card
sex? I like Metro cards.
I'm going to probably say big T-shirt.
Uber? Before she even got to the house? I like Uber sex.
I'm probably say big T-shirt.
I want to fight him.
I want to fight T-shirt him. Myself,
I think. Uber sex.
Yeah, all right.
It led up to the sex.
Mm-hmm, it did. It did.
Uber sex for the win.
All
right. But it depends on what kind of Uber she got, right?
Yeah, because if it's an Uber
pool.
Nah,
they only got,
if,
they
it's
only
a,
got
if it's an Uber pool,
nah,
it's a dub.
They only got one kind of Uber now, by the way.
Oh, there's no Uber pools?
No, there's XLs, and then there's Uber Blacks, and then there's...
well, you can always do the big black trucks,
and then
but
there's
I'm talking,
something else.
I can't do pools no more. You can't
nah,
do,
I know pools yeah, is a dub, yeah, yeah. But I know there's Uber XL, and then there's Uber Work. Black, and then all there's right. something else.
So, big T-shirt for the win?
Nah, I choose bonnet. Bonnet different. Oh, yeah, bonnet spicy.
Okay.
I say jacket.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Hey, before this episode jacket over, sex. I'm gonna fight. Willa.
Something about that jacket when you fully dress. Oh, I love it. Right before the sex, you just got a jacket on. Make me do it. Woo! That get me every time. Every time.
Yo, I hate this nigga.
Mm-hmm.
Why won't he fight me, Dave?
I don't know.
Dave, why won't he fight me?
Leather jacket too.
I'm not going on a joke.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like it. Joke doesn't make me comfortable. Typically, I can roll with it. I'm over here like, I have nothing. You notice I have nothing. I'm like, I just want this sex to go away. Please.
Kathy said, what the hell turned you on about a bonnet?
Well, nothing. I don't think nothing turns a man on.
It's just
women, you know, wear bonnets.
Like, every time I've seen a bonnet.
We got to deal with it, Kathy.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like,
we got to deal with it.
Every time I've seen a bonnet on a woman, I just have had some spicy ass sex. So that's what it is for me.
Well, because it's kind of like they know that their hair part is straight, so they ain't worried about nothing else. They're like, fuck it. You know what I mean?
Like, so anytime I've seen a bonnet, it's like, oh, yeah.
For me, it's the robe.
You like robes?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Robe. Okay. All right. Well, shit.
We have a new entry into the sweepstakes. So, robe sex.
We got to let this go. I can't.
Robe
sex. It's Jason's fault.
I can't.
How?
It's your fault.
We got a new entry. A robe.
I can't with this one.
I'm going to fight you.
Okay. All right.
You going to be mad at me? It's robe sex. Robe sex is lit, though. I like robes.
Let's move on.
Robes, it depends on the material, though.
Yeah, I know.
It can't be that.
Do not, really?
No, you know what I'm talking about. Yeah. It can't be no cheap ass towel material. I want like the silky, satiny, you know, the velvety.
It's got to be thin and it got to feel good.
You feel me? Yeah.
On a robe?
Yeah.
You ever went to a hotel and they had that cheap ass robe?
Because robes, they get hot.
And I've static really electricity. You touch a doorknob and shock yourself. That shit is not sexy. No. That's not sexy
really
at all.
I've never worn a robe. Like,
you've never worn a robe?
Yeah, like I've never had a thing.
You never had one? Like yourself? You never? Mm-hmm. Wow, okay.
Word?
That's interesting. I'm not a robe guy.
I get it. I'm just saying. Sure.
Just throw a towel on and call it a day.
Okay.
I'm
going to get you a robe.
I'm looking like, yo, y'all finna see tennis sweat.
You should have had a shirt under that.
Man, I don't know what the hell I was thinking. Go ahead. This shit gonna be like somebody threw water on me by the end of
the show. Bro, you've been on this earth for 3,000 years. Hey, you should know better than this,
hey, man.
Okay?
Listen.
What?
Listen.
Like, you should know better than
and
this.
The lights got me hot. I'm over here like, I'm...
This nigga about...
Go ahead.
They about to really perspire. You know, I gotta
yeah, y'all.
Yo, what we talking about? Shit, man. Damn.
It's your fault. Talk about it's fucking jackets.
You brought the question up.
Topic one, please.
Okay.
Satin robes.
Really?
Satin robes and high socks. That's some sexy shit.
Mm-hmm. Satin robes
and high socks.
Mm-hmm.
I like high socks.
The longest bad joke I've ever been a part of.
You don't like high socks?
He's Jason Fult, man.
You don't like high socks? Oh, y'all are bugging. High socks, do it.
Okay, press the drop, Dame, please.
I did. It didn't work.
He's like, I did that shit 5 minutes.
I did. I was like, nigga, please, change this goddamn.
This is your damn chair. Nah. You trying to remember you broke the chair? High socks.
Nah, see, God don't like ugly. See,
I like high socks.
The longest bad joke I've ever been and a part of.
You don't like high socks?
He's Jason Fult.
A bugging. Listen, high socks is fire.
Please,
what y'all
stop
about.
It.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go. Move
what
on.
Are we starting with? Well,
is it selfish to not want kids?
Okay.
Shout out to Chris Porter on his check-in. What's going on?
What's happening, man?
I got a question for you fellas. So you're dating a young lady. Willa, you have kids now. But let's just say hypothetically you run into your significant other now and she says, hey, I don't want to have any kids.
Mm-hmm.
Do you feel that it's selfish on her part to then now tell you that she doesn't want kids and you and her are together?
Okay. So is she selfish for not wanting kids?
Yeah.
Well, no.
I'm just asking the question as
yeah, no, first, I get it.
Because you know you're real.
The way I think it's selfish is if you have, well, to me in my head, I could be wrong, or this is just my thinking. If you have so much to offer and so much to give, I feel like it's selfish if you don't. Mm. That's what I'll preface my whole statement by saying that.
So let me make sure I get it.
I'll go a step forward. I'll explain it. Like I believe Oprah is 1,000% selfish.
Because she doesn't have any kids?
Yes, and she doesn't want any. I think that's selfish. You have so much to offer and you have so much love to give and so much resources to give and so much everything to give. Like you don't want to have somebody that you can pass it all down to? You don't want a legacy? No, nothing? Like to me, that's selfish. Now, if you're talking about if you ain't got shit to offer and you just skating through life fucked up, don't have no damn kids. Don't bring no kids in this world.
Them the people that got all the goddamn
kids. I'm trying to say, you better can take care of you. Don't bring no kids in this world.
Right.
But if you got so much to offer and you're like you have so much and you're set, once again, that's in my opinion.
Kathy said it's only selfish if the person waits to state that.
I also feel like that should be a conversation beforehand.
Yeah, that should be
that's
a beginning conversation for real.
Swing it.
Where? Oh,
I feel like that conversation definitely should be had. Because if she said, hey, I don't want kids, then you do, then brother, you need to leave. Yeah. And vice versa. Don't stay around. Because we was talking about that too. You end up getting bitter. You end up being bitter if you stay around trying to persuade somebody to do something that they don't want to do.
Yeah.
And then that turned into a whole nother situation.
But what if this person, you really love this person, or you feel like this person is your soulmate? Someone that you feel like there's no one else for you.
That soulmate shit is bullshit. Because if y'all can't, I'm answering the question. I got it. But to me, that soulmate shit is bullshit. Because if y'all can't agree on something as major as that, then guess what? That's not it.
But there's gonna be a lot of things that you're not gonna agree on.
No, I said major. That's big.
So let me ask you this: every major decision that you and your partner have to make, you agree on it 100% of the time?
I'm talking about kids, bro.
But this is what I'm saying.
There's a hierarchy of major.
Mm-hmm.
That's up there, bro.
And I'm not disputing that. But what I'm saying is, if you and your partner don't agree on something that is of the hierarchy of making a decision, does that mean that you must leave the individual?
I can't see much on that level. That's what I'm trying to say. Like, you're trying to bring it to what's equatable or what's equal to that. I can't see much.
I get what you're saying.
So because of that, I can't answer that question. Because that is so high up there. That's something that you really have to talk about for real.
No, I agree.
Do you want kids? That's a big ass question that you have.
Okay.
In a relationship.
I got you.
That's not like, oh,
I know,
I can get $10. Like, it's not the same.
But I want to change it, because I do understand it's important. But the point is, you I'm just going back and with you. So but it's
shout
selfish.
To Darcel.
But it's selfish for them. You think so? If you
just said just me, okay. and to me, once again, I preface my statement. Right. If you have so much to offer, and you have so much to give,
mm-hmm.
why not? And if you don't, to me, it's selfish. That's me.
Okay.
Y'all obviously have different opinions, or maybe not.
Yeah, no.
But this is me.
I personally do not think it's selfish.
Okay.
If you don't want kids. You know, we always talk only child shit. There's a part of me that don't want no kids. There's a part, because I see how this world is, and how tough that is, and how tough it is growing up in this day and age. And, you know, and I salute the fathers and the parents and the mothers and everybody that's working and fighting to raise kids, but I could understand why a person would say, well, I don't want to do that. Like, I don't want to do that. And then if you have a lot to give, that doesn't necessarily mean you have to give it to children. You know, just because you can give, other people exist, other things. You don't need to procreate to give, is all I'm saying.
There's something about leaving a legacy that hits different with me.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where I'm
to
at.
To you,
with
that's
it.
What it is.
Like, yeah. there's something big about that. Like,
yeah.
So if you just pass and left the earth, like, that's it? That's it. You're done.
But I think there's other ways to leave you. There's other ways you can leave your legacy.
Yeah, that's kind of what I'm trying to say. Because I don't think
I think
I think kids is a default legacy.
Family tree. Yeah. Stop.
You said a default legacy.
Yeah, yeah. It's a default legacy. Because let's break it down.
I agree with that.
It's a default legacy because we're human. We procreate. We have children. That's just human. That ain't like I have a legacy to live. It's like, nah, nigga. That's just what happens.
But we were put here to procreate. So if you're not doing the one thing. Barry got one job, right? That he is, didn't do it.
He'll never do it.
Well, we had one job, and that's to procreate.
Well,
that's
I want to fight.
Well, you could. You lose, but you could.
But that's if you feel that's your one job. You know what I'm saying? Like, some people don't feel like that.
Yeah, I don't feel like that. I just don't. And the thing is, like, I don't judge anybody who feels differently. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what's it called? And I also, like, I believe I'm a person that has a lot to give. Like, mm-hmm. a lot.
Really, no, you don't got nothing to give unless you can have kids, bro.
Yeah, exactly.
It's over.
Exactly.
It's over. We might as well just leave this motherfucker right now.
Y'all some selfish motherfuckers. I'm right there with you. I'm there. Shit, you're goddamn right. Next. Next.
Like, I'll
triple down like a motherfucker. Bro. I don't give a fuck.
Go ahead. I'll let you finish.
Yeah, I just, you know, I mean, I think it just comes down to belief structure, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, for me, like, I feel like my purpose in life is to love and to give, but I don't feel like there's any boundaries there's no specific way that I feel that I'm supposed to do that.
You should be able to give love in any way that you feel that you need to give love.
And that's the reason why I said default. Salida said I would have preferred my way. I would have preferred for my legacy to be in my work and how I impact others. And me as an artist and as a producer and as a podcast, and like, it's very much like I want to have kids. I'm not saying I don't. I'm just saying I can understand people that think like that. But it's much more than just having kids. It's more important that I can move the world. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to salute myself real quick. It was a video floating around where it was one of my tracks and it was in France skating to it. And I was like, yo, I'm affecting people in France directly to the point where these people are legitimately hitting me up. Like, I like this music. What is this skating stuff? They're in France. And to me, I'm not saying that that's more important than having a child. I think once you have a child, that takes precedence over anything else that you're doing. But that's important to me to affect France musically, bro.
But how did you get here? How were you able to affect France musically? Somebody birthed you, right?
Yeah.
So if you were never birthed, you never did that.
Okay.
So we're starting with being birthed, right? Uh-huh. So what if your kid affects more than France now? They affect mm-hmm. France and the whole world. Okay. You did one France. They did everything.
Got you. But what if they don't? It's all an if.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. What if that motherfucker commits murder and they're doing life in prison?
But the same thing with you.
All I'm simply saying is that's why I say it's a default. Because you don't nothing is guaranteed. Right,
mm-hmm.
So nothing is guaranteed, and I'll just be the asshole to say it. We don't know if our kid's gonna be great.
Yeah,
you
could be a
serial killer. You could be a serial killer.
Yeah, I mean, you could have birthed the next rapist. I'm sorry,
you could be the dopest parents in the world.
It.
Do all the
and
right
have
things.
A shitty kid. Yeah, you're
that's
right.
It. That's you know,
get
and,
that
right. So
granted,
so I can't put all of my legacy into my children.
One more time, I missed it. I was reading and listening.
I cannot put all of my life's legacy into just my children.
I never said that either.
Well,
but
no,
Wait,
no one said you said it.
I'm just saying because we like to go extremes here. Right.
Okay.
You're saying, I'm doing this for myself. Look what I've done. I'm not going to put it on. Nobody's saying that.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
You can be a dope parent and a dope legacy person, whatever the fuck you're talking about. You could be both.
Yeah. Which,
so it don't gotta be one or the other.
Yeah. Let me be clear. I want kids, right? So I'm, you know, the plan is to be both. But I'm just saying I would never put all of it into that. And that's why I say when to me, and this is just my opinion, when people put their whole life, like, what were you here for? Just to have kids? Which that may be true. That may be
that's
true.
That's what I'm trying to say. Like,
may be true, but that's why I say that's default.
But we literally go extreme all the time, and it shouldn't be like that.
But that's the reason why I say that's default, though. Because what I would want
and
people to do—
extreme shouldn't be a default. That's not a default.
No. It's not extreme to me. You're human. You have kids. That's literally—
that's not human. All that I do.
No. But I'm saying that's— but that's why it's default. Because it's human legacy.
So like,
you know what I'm saying? Dogs gonna have baby dogs, bruh. So you can't tell me that dog is a shit because they have baby dogs. That's what they do. You know what I'm saying?
I have another cross point to
that's
prove, right?
What mm-hmm. we do as humans.
Screen. You know Screen. Screen don't have kids.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But Screen has affected
this
so—
this a person?
Yes.
I'm sorry, his name
is
Screen.
It's a basketball coach.
Okay, my bad.
Coach.
I didn't know.
I say all the time, if I didn't meet Screen, I don't know what would happen in my life.
Gotcha.
But
okay.
He's affected so many kids,
mm-hmm.
and he doesn't have kids.
Mm-hmm.
And how many kids' lives has he saved just by the simple fact of being a basketball coach?
That's a good point.
But and granted— even if the kid wasn't the greatest player,
right?
He was trash and whatever. I've seen Screen pull his car over when the kid was on the corner doing shit that he wasn't supposed to be doing and grab the kid and say, yo, what the fuck are you doing? Get in my car.
Right.
And we out.
Yeah.
Now, God knows what would have happened to the kid if he stayed, whatever. Mm-hmm. But my point being, Screen's legacy for the rest of his— Screen is probably, what, 70 now? But Screen's legacy from now to the day he dies and forever on will be the fact that, you know what?
He affected mad youth.
He's affected so many youths. And he doesn't have a kid.
We just
and he
celebrated,
will be lived on forever.
We just celebrated Allen Iverson's coach for passing.
Yeah.
Right? He affected a lot of kids. Now, we don't know if he had kids or not.
He did.
But, okay, I don't know.
Yeah, he had.
Okay, cool. My bad. Cool.
But he's not selfish.
Yeah. Well.
See what I did there? You see what I did there?
You did.
You ain't shit for real.
I seen the mind working.
Yeah, come on.
I was waiting for it.
That's only because you knew a little bit more information than me on that one.
Come on now.
But at the end of the day.
Shout out to Miles on the check. What's good, brother?
That's why I just say kids are default. And I think that it's a default thing, you know, because we as humans can, like, that's easy. That's light work.
That's
but
not
do,
easy.
What I will say,
light,
I do
it's
understand
not,
what Will
is
saying.
There's a lot of people who
I
can't.
Do,
so you
I
can't
do,
say it's easy.
I do say that I
okay.
do understand what Will
it's
is
not
saying.
Not easy at all.
Yeah.
Having kids, I do understand what Will is saying in terms of being selfish, not having children. Because if you can help so many kids,
mm-hmm.
why not even make the attempt to help your own? Have your own to help
because
their
it's
own.
Selfish.
But no, that's what I'm saying. I agree with. That's what I said. I agree with what you're saying. Because, for example, you could say this. The same situation. Screen has helped so many youth to the point where he can't even count anymore, right? So why not have your own and try to make the same attempt with your own?
Can I further? Okay,
I don't see why it's selfish.
I want to double down with the selfish, right? I want to double down. Maybe it's the word. Maybe the word is triggering
selfish.
You.
Selfish, yeah.
But
like, I'm gonna
double down and say this, right? I'm gonna double down.
Because then what if your kid ain't shit? Like you tried everything that you did.
That has nothing
kid.
To do with
but,
it.
But what I'm saying is. You can't be a part-time good person, and I say that because people love to be the auntie,
Right.
They want to pick the kid up. Oh, you such a precious little thing. I will be a lit pass uncle. Them off and go about their business.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm a lit uncle.
To me, that's part time being a good person. Like that's why I call it selfish. Like, have something of your own. Don't grab my kid's cheeks and say, "Oh, it's so precious. You're so cute. You so." Blah, 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 blah. I'm at the point. I'm like, "Yo, don't touch my kids." On some G shit.
I'm an uncle to your kids. Why can't touch your kids?
Nah, but I get it.
You know what I'm trying to say?
Like, I do.
Don't be a half ass. You double dutching.
On some other shit?
Pick a side to stay on.
I'm going to say this and it's going to sound crazy, but that's why I don't touch people's kids.
Dead ass.
Like, and
I get it.
And y'all know that about me. I love your kids.
I respect that.
But I'd be like, oh, what up? And then I'm like, cool. That's it. I'm not like, sit on my lap.
I fucking hate that. People come over there like, oh my God. Now people do.
I don't do that.
Peace, nigga. It's like, to me, that's wild selfish, bro.
I don't do that.
If you can be such a great individual with everybody else's kids, you can be a great person with your own fucking kids. That's selfish to me.
Well, hold on.
I agree. That's a different. You just moved a goalpost.
Yeah.
I did.
A little bit.
That ain't just because you like people kids.
I mean, if people are.
If you like kids.
Hold on. There's a difference between faking the front and then actually being. Because I have friends. What's it called? I have plenty of friends that have kids or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure.
And I'm mad supportive of them. And their kids.
So have a play date, Josh.
And there's nothing wrong with that.
No, have a play date.
He's saying have a kid to have a play
date. And have a play date with me. Have a play date, damn it. Let's go to the park.
But the reason why I say this is like, the reason why I think it's actually important to have people around you that are also support you and your kids is because it takes a village this day and age. Like,
okay.
It really, really takes a village. There's so many other people aside from my parents.
Right.
That really impacted me, and I really needed them at a time where I didn't know that I needed them at the time. You know, in hindsight, 2020,
yeah.
I can always look back and be like, oh, that person was trying to tell me something, or that person really saved me there and I didn't even realize
it.
That weren't my parents. So, like,
it takes a village.
So, like, I understand what you're saying. Like, now, if someone just shows up and, you know, touches up on your kids and
touches up on
them. We're not touching up on no kids.
We're not touching up on nobody.
Yeah, that's kind of
no
wild
touching stuff. Up on people's kids.
No,
right?
R. Kelly. Yeah.
What we don't do here.
No, R. Kelly.
Is touch up on people's kids.
We leave R. Kelly
with
him.
But yeah, but you know, but if someone comes around your kids and they fake pretend like they actually care about them, and then just walk away from them, I mean, like, that's one thing.
Right.
But I think, you know, you really are. I mean, let's just be real about it. Especially nowadays, you need people. You need people outside of you to help you.
That's real.
That's real. I just don't think it's selfish. And then Taz said something really simple that it. She said, "Fuck." She just said selfish don't have to be a bad thing in this specific case. Like it doesn't.
Actually, I think selfish is appropriate. But that's what I was getting. That's the other point I was going to say.
When she said, I don't think it's bad.
Because I'll be honest with you. Like, me and my wife don't have kids, but it's something that, like, if we have them, we're kind of at a point like if we have them, we have them. If we don't.
Gotcha.
Sort of thing, but
oh, y'all having kids?
But the truth of the matter is, if you see how much work it takes to have kids,
yes,
and because like having kids is a real relationship.
Oh, yes.
It's a real relationship that is going to be one of the biggest, if not the biggest, mm-hmm. one you have in your life, mm-hmm. and that's going to take real
work.
So why would you not want that
in real time? Well,
some people are scared of that, bro.
No,
I'll tell you why.
Well, here's the thing. Like, if you look at my life.
Just because you're scared doesn't make you.
Yeah, fact. I don't know what you just said.
We're going to let him go?
Yeah. Finish your food.
I'm finished. Just because you're scared doesn't make you selfish, bro.
It's
not about being scared.
It's not scared.
But look at, I'll be honest with you, and I say this with all the humility in the world. I'm leaving a legacy right now at this studio with all the people that I interact with and help all the time with their podcast, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. And you see, what's it called? You guys have seen it firsthand,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Right.
What's it called? It's my passion. It's what I like to do. I like to help people.
Mm-hmm. Right.
If I have a kid, I know that I'm not going to be able to do that.
I disagree anymore. With that statement.
Not at this level.
I wholeheartedly.
Wholeheartedly.
The
dad that I want to be,
yep.
I could not do it at
yes,
this
you
level.
Can.
Wait.
Yes,
I'm,
you can.
I'm a, well,
disagree.
Well, wait.
I don't
wait.
Believe it.
Before you disagree, yeah. Because I got a compliment for you, but I will say, let me just get, and I got you. I believe the same thing. And what happened to me is I dated a girl when I was right out of high school, 19 years old, that had a newborn baby. And we was together on and off, whatever, but for some years. So since I literally was around that little girl's life, like I went through everything that everyone goes through as a parent, the crying at night, the bottles, the walking, the saw you boiling the bottles, the other day. Like I went through all of that. But at the end of the day, I was like, I don't want to do this right now. Mm-hmm. Like I knew that I didn't want to do
which
it.
Which is fair.
And you know, I was 19. I was like, I don't want to do this. And it was cool because I hate to say it like this, but it ain't my kid. At the end of the day, I was like, it's not my baby. It's not. So I'm not, you know, I don't have to be here. And that was the decision when I was like, well, you know what? Since I've already kind of seen how the process goes, and I've literally checked in with this little girl is, what, I don't know, she's 17, 18 now or whatever.
God damn.
Yeah, that's how long ago it was.
You are old as shit, bro.
It don't matter what, yeah, I said. I could say she's
40. Bro, you said you were there when she was a baby, born.
I met her, she was 0 years old. Swear to God, she was still, like you said, months.
87 months.
Yeah, she was 162 months when I met her. I didn't know.
Nothing, you cannot
argue. 3,047 days.
You cannot argue.
Oh, my God. Let somebody tell me that.
Days?
Let somebody break it down to days.
347,000 days.
I'm telling you, she going to hit you with Jaylee. Oh, Jaylee, 17 months? Watch.
Nah, but I kind of was able to kind of like slide out of that because it wasn't my child. And that was the time when I was like, well, you know what? I got very close. Because if I'd have stayed with that girl, I'd have still been, you know, raising this little girl, which is fine. I love her to death. And we still talk and all of that. But that let me know that I want to do this now when I'm ready. Like, I don't want no oops. I don't want no because this is why I'm saying I'm going with Josh, because it does take precedence over what you do. Yeah. Now, real quick.
That's fair.
Let me give this man a compliment. And I mean this. I've never seen a person take as much weight as this guy has done. I've never seen that. Like, I'm telling you, like, everything that I thought when I was 20, like, and this is something, I guess you could say, positive parenting, but if I would have seen examples of that at a younger age,
it would have changed your viewpoint.
I may have felt differently about having kids. So that's what I'm saying. Real talk, I want to salute you for that, because this man is a store manager, you guys. This nigga manages careers, literally, and manages his household, manages his music career, manages his podcast. Like,
yeah,
I'm with that.
I've never said this out loud to you, but I am sort of in.
How do you have time to write raps, my nigga? Where? That's do real. That? I be like, how? And then he don't write one song. He's like, I got 15 songs. Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Straight
something
up.
Wrong with you.
You lie sometimes when you're not acting like an a-hole.
Oh, shit. Shout out to Braulio. That's good, bro. Thanks for Braulio in a minute.
Another dad. Yeah. He ain't selfish.
I salute you.
But I
salute that because, like, yo, I've never seen that in real life. All right, we got to be dragging this
one. And the last thing I was going
to
say.
Shout out to Sheena on the check-in.
Why I say people who say that they don't want to have kids, and I know people who say that part of it is fear. And it's not selfish to be scared of something.
I know, you're scared of everything.
Hey. But because, for example, I know men who don't want to have kids because they don't want to, they're so scared of being their father, they don't want to have kids.
Oh, like acting like their father. I can see that. Yeah.
So because of that, they're apprehensive towards it. Now, I'm not saying that they shouldn't overcome that fear, but you cannot tell a man that he is selfish because he doesn't want to act like his father. Because if you want to, in a warped way, you can say, you know what?
That's being selfless in a way.
And that's what I was going to say, because he's like, you know what? I want to protect my kid that I may have so much from my father that I'm not even going to have a father. I'm not even going to be a father.
That's deep.
And that's some real shit.
That's some. Tune in next week when we explore.
It depends how you look at it.
But
he said cowardice.
Okay, my bad.
I understand that, but you can't. In that position, if he really says, yo, my dad is a drunk, he's abusive as shit.
Yeah.
Fucks me and my mom up.
Right.
And he's like, yo, I have so much of that in me and I can see it. I don't want my kid to ever feel some shit like that. So you know what? I don't even want to have no kids.
I want to keep going on that, but we're going to have to move on, man.
But that
changes it. Because my mom was literally the mom that said, I see how fucked up my family is. I'm going to do differently. You know what I'm saying? Like,
then
legit.
That's a caveat to that. That's like, what I'm saying. That's a caveat.
Imagine if Dame mom was selfish.
Yeah.
We'd be sitting here next to
you. You mean Eve?
That was a good one.
I got that one.
That was a good one.
I was like, what? Where is he getting this? I get that one to you.
I know we're getting ready to move on, but what Amira said right here is so important.
Okay.
What's up?
She said, we came from a generation of adults who had children but were not parents. Choosing to not have kids and create new cycles of trauma is selfless.
Ooh.
That's something I wholeheartedly agree. I mean, granted, that doesn't apply to me.
But
I understand that, though.
I get both sides.
What he said,
devil's advocate, it could be cowardice.
Which
it
I get.
You're running from a problem that's not there just yet? Like, you're running from something that might happen? Like, that's cowardice to me. Devil's advocate.
I can see both sides.
Both sides.
Yeah. All
right. Just gotta be honest.
It's a great one, man. This is a good topic, because that's what I'm saying. This one could drag on, y'all. And we're trying to learn how to not drag our topics.
Facts.
We're trying to learn how to move the
mediate and moderate a roll call selection decision. Barry.
It didn't.
Y'all want to be mad real quick or no?
Why no. We,
no.
Okay. I just asked the question.
That can be last. Okay, sir.
Okay, no problem. I just asked a question. Why aren't men conditioned to be husbands the way women? Shit.
God damn it. I think this was a mirror's question.
My damn beer.
Wives. You want a shot?
Fuck you.
Oh, shit. Just testing. Hey, we going to get him. Hey, real quick. We gonna catch him.
Uh-huh.
You think, how long you think he going to last?
I don't know.
It's me we talking about.
I know who the fuck I'm talking about. How long you think he going to last?
Y'all should know me. I'm not.
All right. So let's do this, man.
Hey, we going to an open bar in 2 weeks. You with it?
No, I'm good.
No, you said you was pulling up to an open
bar. Yes. For real?
We going to talk about it. Mm. Yes. Mm.
Okay. Well, I think this was Amira's question. I believe.
So shout out to Amira.
I believe. And let me know, Amira. I see you on there. That was a good one. Just read it one more time.
Why aren't men conditioned to be husbands the way women are to be wives?
Man, that's good. Mm. And I'm talking like they was arguing for like 3 days on the page. I'm going to put it in the.
I can say this very easily.
Mm. Go ahead. Shoot your shot from early, 40 feet away.
We're not raised like that.
Mm. Okay.
We don't play house. We don't fantasize about our wedding day. That's not a thing that men do.
You know what? I can agree with that.
So because of that conditioning, I guess we're not conditioned for that. Little girls are conditioned. They draw their wedding dress.
Yeah, we play doctor.
You feel me? They they play house. That's a real thing.
We play doctor.
Husband and wife and all that. Like, they got their little baby dolls. And I watched my sister growing up.
Yeah.
It was a thing. She had baby dolls and they were married. And that was their family. And it was a thing. That's the wedding dress. And that's this and this and that. And like that's a thing. Mm. I was given a basketball. I was told to go outside. I was told, you better not be coming in and out of my damn house.
Right.
If you're outside, you're staying outside.
I was told, like, make sure you don't bring home no babies.
Yeah. Mm. That's what we were
shout out to B Condoms, by the way.
Shout out to B Condoms. No, that's crazy. Okay.
But so that would be my, I guess, short answer to the question. Why we're not, quote unquote, conditioned.
No, you can go.
I feel like the reason why men don't know how to be, let me make sure I say it right, because we got over analytical Willa sitting next to me.
Facts. He need a drink.
Why aren't we conditioned to be husbands? The reason why men are not conditioned to be husbands is because I feel like there are no. It's about to sound so fucked up. But we don't have any men in our lives to teach us how to be husbands.
Okay, I can see that as an
because I'm gonna be real with you. 90% of the people I know that have been married are now divorced, and it didn't last more than maybe 2 years. Mm. And because of that, it left you with a stigma that, you know what? Every time you're with a woman or you're with your wife, all it's gonna be is nothing but arguments, headaches, and just.
That is a fucking fact, Bart.
No, Taz agrees with you. She said you're right on target. So, Taz says there's not enough husbands.
So because of that, automatically I remember growing up, the first thing I've ever heard from a man in terms of being married, just know that your life is over and.
That's true.
You gotta
have
nothing but
a fact, Bart. That's I've definitely was
you
told.
You never
that.
Hear being married is the greatest thing ever.
I know.
I love it.
I heard it. I heard it 2 weeks ago for the first time at work.
Yeah, wow.
For the first time from a gentleman at my job, he said, "Yo, I'm not gonna say being married isn't hard, but he said being married is probably the greatest thing I've ever done." And I said, "Wait, what you just said to me?"
Wow. Okay.
He's a black man too. Shout out to him. But other than that, he's the first man I've ever heard say that to me ever. Mm.
Mm. I'll be the second.
Hey.
Okay.
You the number two, but I'm just saying, as a man, I've grown up. From every man I've known that was married or is married, is just, yo, bro.
I can agree with you. Like,
I agree with that.
What I never hear, I hear that it's one of the greatest, like one of the greatest things, but I also hear at the same time, it's very hard. To the point where, like, this dude is telling you this in a bar, drunk, fucked over, like, I love my wife, like, death, but it's the hardest thing. And I'd be like, I don't want to be that guy. I already drink too damn much. You know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to.
Like, homie be looking. The way he went and when he says it, he looks stressed.
Like, but I mean, stress.
At the end of the day, it's a job. So
right.
You don't. You don't talk about your job with high regards.
My job
I fucking
sucks.
Hate my job. You know what I'm saying? Like everybody, I hate my job.
I want to blow
it's,
that shit
it's
up.
It's the same thing. But guess what? You need your job.
Right.
Like it's kind of the same thing. It's fucking work. You got to put the work in.
Right.
That's all. But I guess that's how that comes off when we're talking about it. When men are like, oh shit.
Like right here. I don't know.
Reggie.
Yeah, he just said, I'm getting married in 2 weeks, and all I keep hearing people ask me is, are you sure this is what you want?
Hey, yo, listen.
Nah, because everything changes. It does.
Willa, I'm going to be real with you. How many times did I act? And maybe I'm
you're Willa now.
I'm
about done.
Yeah. He's been Willa for like.
Oh, so you over analytical.
I just happened to hear his name.
Hey, okay.
Willa.
Anyway, motherfucker, piece of shit. Anyway,
thank you. I appreciate it.
How many times, and maybe I feed into the negative connotation of it, but how many times did I ask you once you told me that you were going to do that?
A billion.
I asked
but everybody
damn
did.
Near, like, I say, hey, are you sure?
Everybody asked that.
You know
what I'm saying?
Yeah, everybody.
Granted, I didn't even ask her, though.
I mean.
Well, women always ready.
But that's the conditioning.
But that's the point I'm trying to make.
Yeah, like, women are always ready to get married.
I never asked her once.
What the fuck?
Yeah, for real.
You know what I'm saying? I never asked her once, yo.
It's actually kind of annoying. It's like, because women are like always trying to measure and see if you're going to be the one that they marry. You know,
because they were conditioned from young.
Right.
I never blowing my mind out. Like, I never asked her ever.
Yeah.
Not once. Like,
Amara said no. Tass said that's not true. So they're not conditioned from young.
Okay.
Oh, well, we can't speak on
that. Well, okay.
I do think they're conditioned, but I think they're conditioned. I'm going to answer the question, then I'm going to speak to something else.
Cool.
Okay.
So to answer this question simply, like, I think women are conditioned, and even women who don't feel like they're conditioned,
disagree?
I feel like they've beat the conditioning. That's what I feel like.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right. I feel like if you feel like
you won,
I feel like you beat the conditioning because let's just be real about it. Like, it all comes to, what's it called? We've lived, as far as long as humans have been around, it's been a male-dominated society.
Mm-hmm.
Men can do whatever the fuck they want, whenever they want, however they want.
Yes.
And they've always, what's it called? And women have always been treated as the lesser.
Mm-hmm.
Very true.
So they get to create the rules, and in the essence, they've created the conditioning of being like, this is what a wife is supposed to be. And this is, the conditioning has gotten to the point where, you know, where it's like, this is what you're supposed to be, and you're going to like what you're supposed to be. Mm-hmm. This is what you're going. This is what you want. They're telling women what they want.
I think the key thing you said in there is that this is what you're going to like, not if you're going to like it or not. You're going to like it, and I think that's what people miss.
And that's what you get conditioned into being. Now, if you're not one of those women, you're one of the, in my opinion, the few who, you know, and granted, like, there's conditioning to different levels and stuff like that, but like, you're one of the few who, you congratulations, you beat the conditioning,
right?
But to speak to your other point though, but to speak to something else that you guys said though, like, and I just, you know, I've said this before, but I just firmly believe this, and maybe this is just my own relationship,
okay,
but like, nothing really changed when I got married. Mm-hmm. I can't really, and granted that maybe that's just my relationship, but like, I just always tried to seek out a partner. I mean, granted, like, I wasn't ever looking for a partner, but like,
I've said that from jump.
Like, right. I always wanted to find a woman that could take care of herself, and then I was going to take care of her. Like, that's what I was going. That's what I.
God damn it, man.
That's some real shit.
I think
you need to say that one more time.
Yo, one more time.
What did I say?
I
wanted to find a woman who can
take care of herself,
and then I would
and
take
then
care of
then I would
her.
Take care of you. I really like
that's
that.
That's some real shit, bro.
Just speaking on marriage, because a lot of people, like, man. We
because, like, the same pressures that I felt before I got married are the same pressures that I feel now.
Right.
Because in my mind, I was already there. The act of getting married was just a formality that had already occurred in my mind already.
You want to know how real it is? Because I know I'm not conditioned to be a husband. And I'm being honest as shit.
Sorry,
about
I'm gonna laugh at that.
No, but like, I don't care. But guess what? It's to the point now. Like, Will is my brother, right? I watch his relationship with his significant other so closely, just so that I can learn. And you, I don't want to say it like that, but you're a test dummy, bro. And I don't mean it in any bad way, but because I don't
I'll be
know,
the first. I'll take the arrows.
You know what I'm saying? Because you didn't, and then now someone's supremely close to you is like, yo, I'm about to do this. It's like, wait, what you about to do?
Mm-hmm. I mean, but you
I kind of want to do that, but I don't know how to do it. So I bet I'm about to, why you did that though? Because that looked funny a little bit. You know what I'm saying? But why wouldn't you do that though? So makes it kind
of. And I'll tell you to add on to that. I have a lot of friends that's married, you know, and a lot of them they're pretty happy, pretty solid with their marriages. But I also don't. But I don't have a lot of people that I know that are married that do entertainment, right? Mm-hmm. I'm from the suburbs of Chicago. Like, I never wanted to be the suburban dude with my suburban wife, my suburban job, and my suburban van, and my kids go to the suburban school. And I always hated that. You know what I'm saying? The same way how people be like, I hate the projects. I don't want to be a project type person.
Yeah.
Always just like, okay, be husband and be married. Show me good examples, but be, you know, Will and Jada or whatever. I don't know. This first one.
Period.
But whatever. Be, you know, what I do and married and successful. Mm-hmm. And that you like never see. Right, we talk about all the people who are celebrities. They get married, they get divorced. The Cardi B shit, the whatever the shit, the blah 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 shit. Right, everybody get divorced, and I'm like, well, it seems like people in entertainment can't stay married. It seems like people who doing what, basically everything that I do in life, it seems like those people can't stay married. And I'm like, I just want to see examples. You're a good example of this now coming up. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But I mean, in real life, I don't see examples of people in this field that stay married and stay, you know, and they pop.
But I could tell you why.
Yeah.
Because they keep people out their fucking business. Mm-hmm. This happens a lot, bro.
Yeah.
J. Cole's been married for a long time.
Yeah.
But because he stays out of people's fucking way,
right,
he can thrive and in his marriage.
Kendrick Lamar, same thing. He's been married for a while.
Bro, it happens a lot.
Yeah, people didn't know that Chadwick Boseman was married. I know.
But it happens a lot. So, like, you're talking about the Cardi B, cool.
But that's my point.
Well, but she's like the outlier, technically. Because if you look at everybody else, the hundreds of other people that's been married in the industry, they just not out there being all, hey, look at us, married in the industry.
It's not that. It's just that, like, when you said examples, so when we don't see examples, that's why it goes back to, when you don't see that, I don't believe that it can happen. Like, I'm almost at the point where you cannot tell me you can be a famous rapper for real and marry someone that's not like Jay-Z and Beyonce. Like, you would have to be Jay-Z to marry Beyonce. That makes sense to me. But, like, Jay-Z couldn't just marry Keisha from the block. And now Keisha from the block been ready to get married her whole life, looking for her Jay-Z. You know what I'm saying? But Jay-Z can't just, like, I've never really seen these examples. Mm-hmm. So when you meet regular people on a regular basis, these are the Keishas. These are the Jennifers that work at the whatever. She would just work at the furniture store. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm just saying, like, I want to get married too. You know?
Shout out to Jennifer at the furniture store.
Shout out to Keisha too.
I'm sitting there, I'm like, I know her.
We've seen her.
You see her on lunch break all the time.
Keisha,
you know what I'm saying?
Too. Shout out to Keisha.
There are a few. Like, she mentioned Ice Cube. It's a few. It is a few.
That's more than a few, bro. Well, don't say a few.
Okay, but when we compare the tumultuous relationships that we know compared to the few that we know that work.
You can only name three that you know. The tumultuous.
Well, let's be
Cardi B. Name another one.
Well, let's be real about it. When a relationship is going well,
you never know.
You never hear about it because that's not news to anybody.
But that's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the reason why you don't hear about it.
It's like an iceberg. You only seen the tip.
Yeah. I'm not even going to go in terms of entertainment and notoriety in terms of the relationship. I'm talking about simply what's in arm's reach of me. And I don't know a lot of
married,
you know what I'm saying?
Wonderful
I don't.
People.
You know what I'm saying? So then when you finally do see it, it's
I know
so,
a few, but not a lot.
When it becomes foreign, I've realized certain things. When it becomes foreign, you automatically think it's something negative.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a bad way to think about things a lot of times. But for example,
speak for yourself. That's what I was saying.
No. Okay, fair enough. Okay, I'll speak for myself.
Speak for yourself into your own experiences.
Right.
Because if I see something different, I don't automatically assume it's negative.
But I'm talking about I'll speak for myself instinctively. When you see something foreign, and I'm talking about something extremely foreign as a marriage, the first thing I think when I hear somebody say they married, I'm gonna be like, oh shit, that shit not gonna work. I've said that.
But that's pessimistic by nature, bro. You gotta fix that.
I'm not saying that you're not right. But it doesn't change the fact that naturally people see marriage like that. Because that's all we've been seeing.
That's all we ever.
Love that's all and we've seen. Marriage, love and I'm not saying. And I'm not saying that I'm not saying anybody's relationship won't.
You remember how Al Bundy used to act with his wife?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
but you gotta be real.
My dad thought he was Al Bundy. Like, he, you know, like that was a normal thing. Like, they love their wife, but they always like, ugh. If you was anybody else, I'd be happier.
Yeah. Can I tell you one other thing about like and this is, I don't really try to like, I don't mean this to really like, to shade other guys or whatever, but like the one thing that I can't stand is when like another dude who's married wants to come up to me and talk to me about like and commiserate in their misery.
Yeah, how shitty his marriage
is. Like, hey, bro, you on that side?
Right? Yeah, right. Yeah. Right,
I'm like
right.
The last thing I wanted. The last thing I want to do is, and it's not
bring negative vibes into my.
Yeah, like I'm not trying to like I'm not like what's going on. Don't get me wrong. Like I know everybody needs somebody to talk to and everything right. Like that. Blah blah blah. Whatever. And that's not to say that shit doesn't go. You know, shit doesn't go south in my marriage at times. You know,
yeah.
You know,
life. Nothing is perfect. But,
yeah,
I get that.
Yeah, but like, at the end of the day, I'm just like, I'm not here to commiserate over your misery in your marriage. Like,
yeah,
I
agree.
It, yeah, and that's something that really just get that's one of those shit things that gets on my nerves. Or misery loves company. I am not that dude. I am not going to be your company.
Keep your miserable ass over. Yeah, damn.
I'm not going to be your company. Yeah. I'm sorry.
I don't like that either, though.
Yeah.
Just okay. All right.
So when I see those dudes, I react the same way you do. I don't give them no time. Yeah. I don't give them my time.
Yeah, I hate that.
I don't like negativity, period.
Yeah. Especially when it's from a random person. Yeah. You ever just been standing there and that dude in the store is like, well, you know how it is with the wife. You're like, no, bro, I don't believe that. Yeah. He's like, whatever she said. Like, I don't have that experience, sir. Yeah. Like, I don't know exactly what
you're that ass over there.
Like, I don't know what you met that dude before?
What the fuck you talking about?
He's like, you know how it is with her. You like, not really. I don't know that.
But once again, it's a lot of things that fall into play why men aren't conditioned to be husbands.
And the same way women are
the
to
same.
Be wives.
You got to continue that sentence.
Like, it's a whole topic. It's a whole topic.
But
yeah.
I still think, even though the women disagreed, I still think women are way more conditioned to be wives than men are conditioned to be husbands.
Yeah, I think that's a fact.
That's a fact. I'm sorry. I don't give a fuck who disagreed.
Like I said, if you beat the conditioning, like really,
congratulations.
Congratulations. Like, it's not a joke.
I'm not saying that a lot of you haven't. And like Josh, I'm even piggybacking off of that. A lot of y'all have beat the conditioning. But naturally, the first thing I know growing up, I've heard from four women is just straight up, yo, make sure you get a husband. Make sure you better get. Make sure you get married. And I know your mother's told you that several times over.
And we West Indian, bro. That's a thing.
For women, get married. For a man, no, have enough mad babies
but
and
not
mad women.
But not even get married. I've literally seen my aunt tell her daughters, like, yo, you better be able to cook and clean for your man.
Right.
Your future man, they ate.
Right.
Like, you better be able to do this. You better be able to do that. It is a conditioning.
That's stress on a kid.
It's a conditioning thing. Yeah. I've seen it. Yeah. So don't tell me. Like,
she ate. She worried about a man she don't even know yet.
That's true.
Boys, I don't
so
even
that's
like
why
them.
When she playing with her doll, she's like, I got to make sure that I cook the meal. Because
let's clean the house.
When Ken doll come home, Barbie going to be mad.
Exactly,
you know,
right.
I already know. Yeah.
That is conditioning like a motherfucker.
Yeah. And they don't teach us that, man. Not as kids. No. Not boys. No.
What's the next topic? Mediated, moderated, roll call, select decision. Barry.
How to get money out of a man?
Cool. Let's 2 weeks in the fucking making. Let's
Wait,
talk about it.
Let's do the Forbes joint.
You want to do Forbes?
Because it's smaller. It's not gonna go as long. Please.
Okay.
For me,
cool. Shit.
I thought that was small. I thought this one was small.
That's what you think. We're learning how to shorten them. Right. Can I call audible, please?
Do your thing.
My fault, bro. I want to do the Forbes joint because I think it's
lead it off.
Go. No. You.
Cool. So the Forbes list, they bugged the fuck out. So they they had a topic, an article written, and it said, the second wave of stimulus checks are coming.
Mm-hmm.
Can the black community wait? In Forbes. So everybody was like, wait a minute.
Like, what?
Did we just read that right?
Yeah.
Can the black community wait? So they, after receiving hella amounts of flack, they changed it to, can the low income community wait? That's how they fixed that.
Way better, right? Way better.
Wow.
So my question that I had with this topic was, why is poverty automatically associated with being black?
Ooh.
I be doing my thing sometimes, you know. I'm here.
You see why I wanted to go here? I love it. And it's a change of topic. You know
these motherfuckers did that. They changed it from the black community to low income community.
Why is poverty
So why is poverty associated with being black? Associated. Because to be honest, a lot of people waiting for those stimulus checks.
Yeah. Right.
Small business owners.
Most of America, which is not black. What are we talking about?
But they went out their way to right. say, can the black community wait? Like, we just beating down the door at the White House. Yeah, give us our stimulus checks. We need this money.
We need your government.
We need this money.
Yeah, man.
That shit's real unfortunate, too, because it's like.
This is the Forbes.
Yeah, the premise of that article.
Oh, you read it?
No. The premise of the article sounds like it's something worth reading, but how they framed that.
It was so bad. Yeah.
So bad. Like, that's crazy.
I didn't even know they said that to you. You know what I'm saying?
You put it in the chat. And I went and read it. I didn't read the whole thing, but I definitely, you know, you go.
How y'all feel about that?
Poverty being black?
That black is associated with poverty.
I mean, that's a very deep question for me personally.
Why blacks are
associated with poverty?
Yeah. For me, that's a deep question. Or for me, that question kind of hits home because like I grew up in a nice neighborhood, so.
It makes you feel like.
You ain't see poverty.
No, so I didn't see poverty. And
you was all right.
No, yeah, but like I felt like growing up, like everybody. You know, it's really weird, even as an adult still, when people mm-hmm. meet me for the first time, especially, and it doesn't matter what race you are, to be honest, when people meet me for the first time, mm-hmm. they automatically make the assumption that I know what poverty is.
Because
I'm black.
Right. Yeah.
So it's a condition. So like, you know, there's not to use the conditioning word again, but it's like we've been conditioned to believe that.
Yeah.
And so... I don't know where I was going with that.
Can the black community wait?
Yeah, but that's just a wild.
Can you wait? Can you wait, brother?
You're black. You're in the community. Like, can you wait? Like,
when I read that shit, I was like, get the fuck out of here.
Nah, that's crazy.
I don't even know what to say to that.
No.
Can the black community wait for the second round of stimulus checks?
When I first got my stimulus check, I was hype as shit. But now it's like.
Can you wait for the next one?
I mean, I want it. I want my shit. Send it in. Come on, I want all parts.
Get my money though.
But
we'll hash this out after the check.
Send that in. Trump sign that. Yo, what are you talking about? But
that's crazy.
Kathy said,
because of the music, you really don't hear other races talking about their low income status. I mean, Eminem spoke briefly about trailer park homes, but who else? Country music don't do it.
So is it
in our music?
Country music talk about being broke.
It's more than just
they talk
music.
About worship than being broke. But I am
being
not poke.
I mean, I think part of it is, I mean, if you look at what's it called, if you look at all of the flyover country, all of Middle America, mm-hmm. they're broke as fuck. They're just as broke.
This country.
This shit that drives me crazy because like, and they what's it called? This is something I tell people all the time. I'm just like. The middle of the country white people are literally just as broke as black people in the inner city, but they still believe that they're middle class based solely on the fact
they're white.
They're white.
Yeah.
Yo, what's crazy?
What is poverty?
What we call broke here. If they were to go anywhere else making the same amount of money,
that's why I just asked that question.
That's why I just asked that question. What is poverty? Because I went to school in Jacksonville, Florida.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The shit I seen.
That's different.
In Florida.
That shit different.
The shit, them backcountry roads.
My whole family's from there.
When like, there's one
your
light.
From Jacksonville?
Jacksonville, Florida.
Bro, there's one
Yo,
traffic light.
That's the worst
light.
Place ever.
Yeah, for real.
There's one, bro. There's
you
one
ain't
traffic
lying.
Light.
It's the worst place ever.
Like, so what is poverty? Like, because can the black community wait? There's a lot of people in New York that you might say they broke, but trust you me, they not broke.
That shit different. Listen, that shit's different.
Listen, I mean, they struggling. They struggling in New York.
There's
but if
no
they
cement
taken,
roads.
Yeah, bro.
It's 2020.
This entire country is 80% broke ass white people. Like,
wait a minute! Don't Nick Cannon us now. Don't be here.
No.
That's not Nick Cannon.
No, that's not Nick Cannon. I'm serious.
Okay.
I may say 74%, but like you say,
I'd
you,
rather
if
you
just,
word a lot.
If you
throw the word a lot instead of a number.
That's true. But if you just drive, dog, I just drove to Chicago. Through Ohio.
Yeah.
Like, drive through parts of Indiana.
But we then know people, Ohio
you
bad.
Can see it, though. I'm
LeBron
saying Indiana.
Resurrected
but I'm saying,
Ohio.
But I'm saying, no, he did, like, personally. Like, but Indiana, these places where it's just like, what the fuck is this? Parts of Michigan. What? Like, and you look and you're like, this is terrible. You know, and that's poverty.
So can the black people wait? Can the black community wait? I'm dead ass.
Can we wait?
They switched it from black to low income.
I mean, you know what that is? That is a room full of editors with no black people in it.
But why are we still going through that? Like, why is that still happening? Well, like, H&M had a debacle. Mm-hmm. Them niggas shit the bed. I don't know what the fuck happened, So we had that. And then after that, it was Gucci who did some stupid shit with the
nooses.
So they did the nooses and that.
No, from what I heard about
it's consistently happening. So now the Forbes, now they have a debacle. It's like, how is this consistently happening?
From what I heard, Gucci did that purposely because they know that once they do some shit like that,
that's bullshit.
We going whatever, but then the sales will go up because people are just going to the page.
So that's bullshit.
All right. That's what I heard. That's what I heard.
Well, I can't believe at this point that these people are this removed. I just can't believe
it. I can. I definitely can.
You think so?
Oh, absolutely.
You remember, wait.
You're giving them way too much credit.
Remember, we worked at Abercrombie & Fitch overnight, right?
Yeah.
And remember when they used to claim the owner would come into this?
All the black people had to go off the floor.
All the black people would have to come off
the floor. But Barry, that was a decade ago.
That shit can still happen now.
She can still happen now.
Listen, we live in the phone era now. Like, everything is like extra.
All that is you'll see the fuckery on Facebook later. You know.
So wait, they made the black people come off the floor for real,
bro? They would say, "Yo, everybody, go take lunch." They'll do like, "Yo, go on break
overnight," right? You know, you gotta. And if they said the owner was coming, we have to. It still would have to look extra pristine. One, and then two. If they had any leads in the morning who were just going to do walkthroughs with him, they had to make sure that they were either fair-skinned or white.
I could even come up with the argument that they probably came up with for why they had that headline. No, seriously, here's how it's, and I'm going to do it in a voice, too. I'm going to try to.
Uh-oh. Okay, let's see.
So even voices.
We are live.
So even if somebody was, was asked the question, like, how do you think black people would feel about this headline? Well, you know, I think it's going to sound like we're really caring about them at this point in time, like, you know, it's not insensitive because we're really trying to hone in on that community.
Yeah. We're trying to shed light on their
that. and that's how you justify that shit.
Yeah,
that's exactly how it happens. Yeah. Just like that. People think it's like, it's not always some, like, don't get me wrong. It's racist, but it's not like
they don't realize what
it's not
saying.
Overtly.
It's not overt. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how a lot of this little shit happens. Cause like, to me, like, don't get me wrong. Like, it's a fucked up headline, but like, I'm just moving past this. Cause like, it's out of all the things that,
you know what I was listening to? I was listening to a podcast, right? Yeah. And I'm just to prove the point where people associate you being black with certain things. And the girl said she works at a Fortune 500 company in terms of sales and shit like that.
Right.
And she said this white person walked up to her in her job and said, oh, mind you, she's a light-skinned girl. The first thing the lady walked up to her and said, white girl, she said, oh, have you ever heard of crown fried chicken?
Mm.
Now, why you ask me that?
But I get
But
what if she genuinely just wanted to know about it?
And then she just said, okay, why? She said, oh yeah, why? She said, oh, because you know, I've never eaten there before, and I figured that you ate there, so I just wanted to know what it's like.
But
she's like, well, yes, I have, but fuck you. But
wait,
I have.
You know what I'm saying? You automatically
fuck you for asking me questions. I got the answer too.
You automatically allude to the fact of thinking that at Crown. Granted, I did eat at Crown, but.
See, that's where you got to flip it on them and just be like, I didn't know you were so uncultured.
No, well, I mean, all right.
You and I would do that. Yeah. But, you know, it's different.
It's so much I want to say.
Say it.
No, but
I'm trying to paraphrase.
I've been that guy. Like I said, I was raised in the suburbs. I worked at Orland Park, Illinois, people know. Suburb out of Chicago, and I was that black guy that people would walk up to. The white guys would walk up to me and be like, so yeah, so blah blah blah, Jeezy this or blah blah blah, rap that. And I'm just like, yeah, I don't listen to Jeezy. And he's like, what, dude, you don't listen to Jeezy? I'm like, no, not really. I mean, he's cool, but like,
you didn't listen to Jeezy when Jeezy was hot?
I didn't care.
What the fuck was wrong with you?
It was other
Everybody
shit going
listened
on.
To Jeezy.
It was other shit going on. It was other music going on.
My
bro.
President is black.
I was literally
my
learning.
Lambo blue. What?
Did not care. I was like, yo, the Roots got a new album out right now. Let's listen to these guitars. And that's my point is, everybody ain't the same. We're not one linear people.
Nigga, respect you ain't black.
You know what I'm saying? And the craziest shit. No, but they would tell me that. And that would be the joke. It was his name was Tom, which is hilarious. White dude named Tom. And they was like, yo, Tom is blacker than you. I was like, because he listened to Jeezy?
It ain't worse than Tom Cotton.
Stop.
That nigga, damn, bro. You
know what? But real quick. Yo. Wait, but let me give
how
you
your name, Tom.
Let me give
real
you
quick,
one
Miami Cotton. Beat Boston, and now they are up 3-1.
Miami's up 3-1?
We knew that was going to happen.
All right. But I just want to say, it was crazy to have white people tell me that thing. I don't know if you ever had this. They always say, well, they say, you're black, but I mean, you're not black.
Oh yeah, I got that
moment. Oh yeah,
and I was like, "What is that?" He was, and they would try to explain it, and I would just love it. Oh, bro, I fucking love it. I'm like, so tell me what that means.
I mean, but Joe Biden literally just said, if you don't vote for him, you're not black.
Right, like, but I'm saying, they would say, well, you talk like you're black, but you don't talk with that. Like the twang.
They can't tell me no shit like that.
You know,
they couldn't tell me.
You know what y'all niggers do. You know, y'all, you're not niggerish.
Can you imagine
like
somebody
that?
Telling me and Willa, hey, you black, but you not black.
It's a very, like, it's a very interesting thing because you have to, and that's why I say it comes back to the article. You have to like, you have to in your brain try to figure out, is it literally out of ignorance of not knowing, or do you know and you got an angle? What I learned.
I don't even know no more.
And that's what I'm saying. So that's why I can wrap this up. What I learned from being around all them white people, it was both sides. There was legitimately white guys who had just never dealt with black people. And I'm talking like
they're not racist. They
and
just
that's a, and that's a, I mean,
and I'm talking like it's not
facts.
It's
right
not
now
a racist thing. It's just legit.
They just never dealt with.
Oh, hold on, it is a racist thing, but it's not.
But it's more of a stereotypic thing. Yeah. It's not really racism. Yeah. It's kind of like they just never seen it. And then what they would say, and I'm telling you, like this is why I do podcasting. But I would ask, well, what do you mean? Talk to me. He was like, well, there's only two black guys in my school. One of them sells crack, and the other one, we don't even consider him black. And I was like, huh, it's a concept to even white guys. They're like, well, he's not black. I mean, that's just Steve.
You can't. You can't say no shit like that. But I'm going to be like, fuck you bro.
But other than just being angry, what I would do is ask more questions. And so what would happen was I started to develop conversation with them.
Because
I was like, so you just haven't been around that many black people. And they was like, no, not really. I was like, so if I'm not throwing a ball or dribbling, oh, and I can speak articulate English to you, that's weird to you? And he was like, well, kind of, yeah, because most of the black dudes talk like this. And I'm like, all right, now that's racist.
That.
Yeah. I'm like, all right, we got to stop.
Oh, yeah. Well, here's the thing. Just to speak to your point a little bit, Barry, about like how, like, yeah, like, oh, yeah, I would have smacked him for that. I would have fought him for that. I did that my whole life. And then after a while, you get exhausted from
you
doing.
Do.
You get
do
exhausted. I did it for 15, 16
you
years.
You can't fight everybody.
You can't fight everybody. Like, okay. I was getting in fights every day.
Bar, you're not that big, bro.
You're not.
Yeah, you ain't that big,
bro. You ain't that big.
You ain't that big.
Yeah, you ain't that big. You've been lifting for 2 weeks. Yeah. Like,
been more than 2 weeks.
All right, 2.5. I'll give you 2 more days, but still, like, relax.
You a hater for real. Mad salty.
Anyway, man, listen to the podcast.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah. We can move on.
Let's move on.
Nah, but fuck the Forbes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can the black community wait? Like, we the only people
and
waiting
mind
for
you,
stimulus.
I used to go in there every year.
Everybody jobless.
I used to go in there for the Forbes list every year. I ain't going no more.
Lies. You ain't have to lie to the public like that. You ain't not have to lie to the American public.
I'm really not going to.
No, watch it. Well, the truth of the matter is,
he's like, I'm going to delete the app now.
Well, here's the thing. Barry ain't going to the Forbes list for anything anyway. Like, yeah, what are we talking about?
No.
Barry is not readable.
That's a lie.
Barry is not readable.
I said I used to go to the Forbes list for like, For the top 10. You know they do the every year top 10.
They do the top 10 rappers and
richest, whatever. Yeah. And that's what I used to go. That's the only thing I used to go for. Mm-hmm. But now I ain't going there no more.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying?
Fair enough.
I deleted all the Tory Lanez songs on my phone.
You ain't gonna lie. Wade's in something real too, though.
Wade?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Wade is
over here?
You not here.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to Wade Mama.
Mama Wade.
Wade in the building.
Happy birthday to Wade Mama.
Hey, Wade, you got to tag all your people from wherever you at.
Because that statement he made is real. Like,
yo, Wade be working.
I've definitely grown up catching it from both sides.
Say one more time.
You end up catching it from both sides because it's just like, it becomes mind-blowing that white people that you've grown up with your whole life and you've lived in the same exact experience that they have, and they expect you to be different from you. And then when you be around black people, they also are then saying that you're not black enough as well.
Right.
And like, and it puts
it
you in,
down to what
that's what Pac faced.
And that shit gets angering as fuck. I'm not gonna lie to
it
you.
Is.
And it becomes a weird thing because it's like, it's one of those things that like, it doesn't really come up as much in my adulthood, but when it does, I'm just like, wow, I still have to deal with this.
Yeah.
At the age of 34.
I read that in Charlemagne's book. Charlemagne said growing up, he was really good in school. Like he was doing his fucking thing. Like he was very smart. But all his cousins sold drugs. So when he was in school, it was a dope thing because Charlemagne's a smart guy. But when he goes home, his family's like, why are you so weird? Why are you reading?
Yeah.
So, like I made fun of. So he ended up was like, well, fuck it. I'm about to just sell drugs and be like y'all because I want to fit in with y'all. So it's like he never found a home.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He was too smart for his family, but not smart enough. It's like it's a weird dichotomy that you got to like fight.
My cousins called me Carlton. They thought I was rich, smart, reading. Like they just thought I had everything. They was like, you got all the game systems. You are like this. And I'm like, nah, we just broke in the suburbs, bro. Like same shit. Like we just broke out here.
I mean, I ain't going to hold you. Growing up, if you had all the game systems,
one game system.
That's one more than a lot of motherfuckers.
Yo, bro, hey, if you was the cousin who had the game system and you was coming to my house, you had to bring that shit every time.
I remember I went from Super Nintendo to like PlayStation. I missed WoW systems in the middle.
I went from
like I Sega CD, Sega Saturn. I didn't have that.
From my, Sega Genesis.
I had none of that shit. So if you
Sega
had
Genesis,
that, you had money. Fuck you.
I had Genesis and I had a PlayStation. Legit.
Sega Genesis to a Dreamcast, right?
Oh, Dream. If you had Dreamcast, you had money.
Right?
Dreamcast was
expensive. Dreamcast was expensive.
It took my mom and me. You had money. Cool.
You had money.
But then once the shit broke, I had. You had
broke a Dreamcast?
Bro, after a while.
Dream deferred.
The shit wouldn't read the CD no more. I don't know if anybody know what happened with the Dreamcast.
That was an inside joke. That was hilarious.
It stopped reading the shit. And then I had to save. I saved all my money for a PlayStation 2. I'll never forget it. I saved all my bread for a PlayStation 2.
Wow.
And they robbed me of the crib. And I was tight. I wanted to fight so
Dreamcast
bad.
Cost way too much and I had no that many good games.
I had three games on that shit.
Yeah, three.
One was 2K. That
you
was
know what
it.
I'm saying? And
AI was on the cover.
And then they had the NFL game that everybody played.
Graphics were crazy, but
crazy.
At the time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Right. Shout out to Dreamcast.
What's
the
third game? What?
Is the shooter game?
No, Marvel vs. Capcom. Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit, yeah. But once again, I didn't have it.
I think that's why my shit broke. That's I think no.
You got money. Rich had money.
No, I had it. That's the only game I had, and it, I think that's
I never
why
had
I broke
because
my cousin used to fight and then kick it.
Dreamcast was people
no,
with money.
Marvel vs. Capcom used to start fights in the crib.
And then once I got PlayStation, it was just a wrap for me.
I had Super Nintendo and then PlayStation.
Once I got PlayStation,
I miss WoW systems. Yeah. What's the next topic? Mediator, moderator, road call, select extension.
Oh,
you had a Dreamcast, Mark.
Crazy taxi. Hey, like
what system?
The demo.
The demo.
What system?
I think
that was Dreamcast.
Nope, never played it.
Okay.
I just told you I ain't had a shit.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You gonna ask me if I played the game on the system?
I'm sorry. You feel.
You wanna know how broke I was?
No, you mad
hey, Josh. You wanna know how broke I was? I had the system, but no memory card. So I started from the beginning every time.
Oh, I'll go a step further. I had a PlayStation.
You had to beat the game all in one shot.
I had a PlayStation, but I only had the games that came in the box. I played Spyro to that motherfucking.
Yeah, oh, I killed Spyro.
That's all I had,
bro.
Yeah. Spyro.
You know what it is to play a game.
Spyro and Crash
start
Bandicoot.
From the beginning every time you turn that bitch off. Oh.
Take a shot. Take a shot.
We
take a shot.
That in a long
time. Take your shot.
Did you really?
Take your
shot. Yeah.
Dun. Take your shot, cuz.
Get a shot of that Bacardi Limon.
Pour that. Pour that.
I said,
pour that Bacardi Limon that you're trying to hold in the cuff over there.
Mm-hmm. 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 No, he should get some Cerveca.
Get some nasty.
Well, why you at it? What's the next topic, man?
How to get money out of a man. You
cool.
Shit, do we have the
I have four of them. I don't have
to play.
It's a 6-minute video. I don't think you want to play all six.
Do you know all the rules off the top of your head?
I wrote them down.
Can we play it?
You deleted them?
Remember, yeah.
From that actual?
There's only four because remember we weren't
gonna Barry's a muck, bro.
I have four of them. That's Yo. What I asked you if you have remember. I asked you in the crib if you remember them.
I wrote them down for a reason. You really deleted them? I'm not tapping shit.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. What Tez said was real though.
What's
like,
say?
What's it called? You know, if you couldn't, what's it called? Yeah, air tap.
Air tap.
Nah, what's it called? If you didn't have a memory card or whatever, you just you paused the game and
left it on
and left it on and slide the console underneath. Yeah,
no, it's a fact. It's a fact.
It's a fact. Or you cover it up. I would throw like a hat or something on top of mine. Yeah,
my PlayStation didn't come off.
Yeah,
I turned a fan on the shit.
Yes,
overheat. Mm-hmm. Overheat. Yep. Wow, that's old school, yo.
That shit,
you an old school gamer. Because
if your shit turned off and you got mad for, you got to start all the way over.
Because I ain't thought about that shit in a long time.
I haven't thought about that since the last time I did it. Yeah. Like, that's crazy. Wow, yeah. All right, take that shot, bro.
I'm mad Barry deleted what we was just about to talk about. We can't even talk about it.
Delete it?
Okay, so all I have is
one job.
One job.
Like, yo, he ain't done nothing
right.
Bruh.
Can you take a shot right? Can you do that?
He gonna miss. he gonna dribble that shit. Like, come on, bro. Get your life, sir.
Bacardi Limon is lime juice.
Good what? Shit. I mean, that's what he brought.
With lime juice.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, you trying to
take
read.
Take your shot, though. Why you trying to read?
Bro, take a shot so we can get on with the show.
Can we move on, sir?
Come on, we waiting on you. You said the B word. That's what you get. Don't ever disrespect women in this show. Don't you ever disrespect the woman on this
goddamn
show.
And what's crazy is, it's been so long.
Time out. A couple weeks ago, did Willa not use the B word in the context of complaining?
That is true, mm-hmm. But I wasn't about to say that, though.
And then okay. I just said the B word in terms of complaining. Did
wait,
I not?
Wait, how did you say it? I'm sorry, I missed it.
That's
it
true. He didn't reference women.
So how'd you say it?
I said, how the fuck did I say it?
No, but what he's saying is right. He didn't reference women.
I just forgot how he said it. I forgot.
I don't care. We don't say that word.
Wow. Yo,
take your shot. Take your shot.
I just want you to know.
We have worked on this for too many years, goddammit.
I'm fucking both of them up. I don't give a fuck how it ends.
We have worked on this for too many years.
Josh, did we not have this argument a couple weeks ago?
We did.
Oh, I bet. I'm just glad you
did. This shit was like last week. Wasn't
it?
It was last week.
He said bitching. That's a different word.
That's what Willa said.
That's a complaint. That's a whole other word.
That is a whole other word.
And I said you'd be mad as a B.
That's different. Because mad as a...
But that's in terms of complaining.
No,
that's
no,
a complaint.
No.
Said it that way.
That's an adjective. That's a descriptive word about somebody else. That counts as a cuss, and you cussing.
And what you did is an adjective as
no,
well.
No, I didn't. No,
yo,
I didn't.
What you're not going to do is argue about the English language with me, bro. Because
you don't speak English.
You just legitimately use the B word as an adjective.
Yo, guess what? You can't untake your shot. You already took it. You already, imagine. He's like, take it back.
Fuck out of here.
So what's the deal with this stuff? Next up.
Bari deleted.
I have 4 out of the 6, bro.
We had a young lady who was speaking about different ways that women can get money out of men.
Yeah.
It's a 20-second clip.
This is a short one.
There's only 20. She didn't say anything, though.
I know, but this introduces who was saying it, and then you can read the answers.
Well, if I had the answers, I would.
You deleted them?
Bari deleted.
So basically, I'm pretty sure y'all saw this viral video. Let me hit this real quick. My bad. It was the chick with the orange braid weave, which is like, wait. How do you get an orange braid weave? Wait.
You just braid your weave.
No.
You get an orange wig.
It happens to be orange.
That's it.
You're not black.
Oh, it's not a one piece? Like, she didn't just.
You're not black, bro.
I'm pretty sure it was a wig that was braided.
Yeah. Oh.
You're not black.
I just don't know. I'm bald, bro. Like, when it comes to hair, I don't.
Yo, can you plug her in, please?
So it was that chick, and I might have to ghetto it because I don't got the. It's an iPhone, unless you got a little.
I do.
Okay, cool. Because you don't like me to be. Yo, Josh hate when I'm ghetto.
Yeah, we graduated.
He don't want you to be black.
He be like, don't be ghetto. Don't be ghetto.
Don't be black.
So what happened is the video was how long? I don't know how long you said it was.
It was it's a 6-minute video.
It's a 6-minute video.
And she was saying
of her like spitting.
She was preaching on the low.
How women get money from guys, right? So I give you like the first
20 seconds
or whatever,
it's not even a long
just to
video.
Do it, but it's enough, you know what I'm saying, to get
she,
it started.
She literally says nothing.
It's but you know it's this lady, and you got
he
the rest of the answers.
You.
You know, so you got it. So let me know
the right moment. Your mean ass is gonna get fucked good and your bills paid. You understand what I'm saying? Being the nice girl, you have to be know when to be nice. So. First thing to get money out of a man, you gotta know when to be nice and you gotta know when to be nasty.
That's number one.
It's number one. Because you have to keep his attention span first. So you're trying to get money out of him. And there's levels, lady. Again, Alan has been doing this tutorial, you know. But here we are.
So that's where she started. 6 minutes later, she gives us the rules of how to get money out of a man. And we have some of the rules here.
Well, you heard one. No one to be nice and no one to be nasty.
Do you agree?
Yep. No, just go through them.
Oh, you want to go just go through them?
She also said obedientness. She made the word up.
I'm about to say that. No, damn.
She made the word up. She made the word up. We get it. Obedience.
Obedience.
But she said obedientness.
Okay.
I mean, and I wrote word for word what she said. So obedientness.
Orange braid wigs.
Right? Third thing she said was don't give up the cookie. Too quick, mm-hmm. And be a multitasker.
So that's the rules.
Another one she said was, learn how to spend his money wisely. And that's how you get money out of a man.
She said, don't be humble at restaurants. Get large. That's what I have here.
Mm. Well, yeah, I wrote that too.
Okay, sorry.
But yeah, right. Learn how to spend his money. Mm-hmm. Don't give up the cookie too quick. Mm-hmm. Obedientness. Know when to be nice and know when to be nasty.
Right.
If a woman did those four things for you, would you give up some money?
Hell like, to the no.
Like, give her my money.
Would you give? Would you drop the bag on Shorty?
You know, no.
And she went into when she talked about the knowing how to spend his money. Mm-hmm. And I think you said, get the large mm-hmm. versus because she was saying that men like a woman who knows how to spend their money.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like if you know how to spend my money. I don't. Because why are you spending my money?
Okay. You know what? I'm going to...
Selfish dame. I'm
going to answer this question from the perspective of not just...
From
a general sense, right? This works majority of the time because...
Pin it.
Men... Because he... And because one... And the reason why I say it works majority of the time...
Oh, when she did say...
Oh, I remember what else she said.
Suck his dick.
I remember what else she said. I'm sorry to cut you off, but it just hit me.
Something about sucking his dick.
Fuck, I just lost it. You see, God, that's what I wanted to say when I said it, because it wasn't that.
Okay.
I was going to say the reason why it works...
Why did Barry delete this?
The reason why it works is because she said, don't give up the cookie. Right? So when a man doesn't get the cookie, he's going to feel like he needs to do all that he can to get the cookie, i.e. spending money. I'm shutting up.
She said, be interesting. Have interesting conversation. Find something that he is involved in and get involved in it, even if you don't like it at all. If he likes football, she's like, you go on a website, you look up some football stats, and you start talking about football. And because you're showing an interest in what he likes, he's more inclined to spend money on you. That's another thing she said.
That's literally
the only thing you agree with.
I wouldn't have phrased it that way, but like literally for me personally, I'm like, I feel like the way to get a man to spend money, on you is to listen to him. I don't mean be obedient. I mean to listen to him.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Because interested in what he likes.
So I agree with that one point.
That's another thing she said.
That's about
you know what's funny? I kind of wish we could play the whole 6-minute video.
But, it was interesting.
But as she was speaking, this thought came across my mind. She's speaking... It came off ratchet because she's like, oh, I'm going to tell you how to get money out of a man, how to finesse a man. It came off like, ladies, this is how you get a husband.
Right.
Because listen to what she's saying. She literally said, show interest in what he likes. Mm-hmm. Be fiscally responsible. Mm. Who wouldn't love that?
Yeah. No. See, that's the difference.
Be a lady in the street and a freak in the bay.
Freak in the bay.
That's three, she said. What's another thing she said? She said, obedience.
No, she didn't. She said
obedientness.
She said obedientness.
So imagine if you found just a woman who's just into all the things you into. She's just like, she's dope. She can spend money very well. Like, she's like, okay, we don't have to blow the bag on that, but we can blow the bag on this.
That's sexy.
Right?
When you tell her something, she listens to it.
That's sexy.
So literally,
yes, it is.
Fiscally responsibility is amazing.
It's funny. Yes. Like,
don't just spend my money on shit.
I wanted to talk about it last week, but we never got around to it. Literally, she's trying to be ratchet and service like the ratchet folks.
But she doesn't realize how she's actually.
To me, I could be wrong, but to me, it was a very good tutorial on how to get a husband.
Press the ding or something.
Like, I'm saying, like, let me know I'm wrong.
He got a good, what's a good,
like,
point.
Would you not want somebody who's quote unquote obedient? And I don't mean like subservient. Like, what's the word? Subservient?
But if your man tells you something, you listen to what he has to say. And
Taz said, unless she created a system for all women to follow to get a husband, she's a genius and entrepreneur.
That's what I'm trying to say. Like to me, like she was trying to, like, yo, I'm gonna show you how to finesse these niggas.
That's funny, but
that's how she was trying to say. But the six things that she listed was like, no, I want somebody who's interested in what
I'm interested
in. You
should probably talk on the mic, Barry.
Want somebody who's nasty in the bed and nice in the streets.
The only thing she said that doesn't fit the rhetoric is the don't give up the cookie. That's the legitimately.
So that fits the rhetoric of finding
that
a husband.
That fit the rhetoric of finding a husband?
That fits because
if you fuck on the first night, bro, you're not looking at her like your wife.
That's not true.
I can't say that.
Yeah, that's not true.
I'm sorry.
Wait, hold on. Wait. Well,
that's a woman that wants what she wants.
How many first night stands have you had that you wifed? Shut the fuck up. No, can
I?
Not true.
I'm gonna be honest. Can I be supremely honest? The last one I was in. Thank you.
That'd be
the
you.
Last Yo. One. The last.
All right.
The last relation. The last two I was in.
You married that?
Okay, but
it don't fucking count. Thank you.
No, don't do that. All right, you just got married, nigga. Okay. What the fuck you talking about?
This nigga been married.
And all my
one
night stands never turned into nothing. So but I can speak
two
to
of
that.
Them. Two of mine did.
You didn't get married. They
so it's
nothing.
Marriage or nothing. Wait, you say now.
So if it's marriage or nothing, then you nothing counts.
No, because she's
talking. That's unfair, bro.
But she's talking about getting a husband. She's talking about getting a husband.
You were the mic, so then nothing we say counts.
Thank you. That's bullshit.
Why are we here?
What are you talking about?
First and foremost, I've never been pussy. Who you yelling at?
What the fuck is he talking about?
Who
you yelling at? So now niggas get married yesterday. Oh, it's only marriage, and that's what they count. Get the fuck out of here.
But wait, because what she's talking. Well, the reason why I said that is because.
Can I get a corner of some Limon? My bad.
I won't drink it all.
Better watch that nigga.
I want some Limon.
He don't want the nosebleed Sevecca, motherfucker.
I prefaced it by saying the sixth thing that she listed was actually trying to get a husband. That's why I'm saying.
No, I got you.
You're saying don't give the cookie too quick. That's one of her stipulations.
Hey, but I guess Shorty's giving me the cookie quick, and the last two, and I was in a relationship with the both of them. They were my girlfriends.
I mean, I get it.
Well, no, because but I got to be real too, bro. And on some real shit, like honestly, I try to smash fast. Like I try. Like my goal is to knock this out.
Well, I think all men.
No, not that.
Toot your own horn.
No.
Beep beep.
What I'm trying to say is I'm one of them people who kind of like to get that out of the way. Because what I don't like is the sex. I don't like sexual tension for no reason. I don't like that, and I don't know.
I ain't gonna hold you. That's amazing.
No, I don't like it, bro.
Why?
It's fucking annoying. Why? Because it's like I know she horny, I'm horny. It's like why the fuck ain't we fucking? And like a lot of times I've had these type of conversations. No, fuck what y'all think. I've had these type of conversations with people
you
I've
really
dated before.
Old for real.
No, I just be on some yo. We going out. We trying to hee hee. You like steak? I like steak. I'm cool. We trying to fuck. To be honest. You know what I'm saying? You horny, I'm horny. It's been a while for me. Been a while for you. Let's go ahead and fuck. Get this
but
out the way.
But it's the art of deflection.
Now it's over. Wait, hold on. Now it's over. We like it. It's done, right? You like it. I like it. Cool. High five. Cool. Now we can.
That's
just
a high five. That's a punch.
This is punched out in the motherfucking mouth.
You know what I'm saying? I've been lifting the day like Barry. So all
Heard
I'm
it.
Saying is,
I'm not gonna lie. That's the realest shit you ever said.
But no, in real
I
life,
really, I really believe that.
No, but I'm serious, and I'm not even the last one or two, three, like my whole entire life. I'm like. Bruh, since like 20, I'm like, so we trying to fuck eventually, right? So
damn,
why must me
80 years ago?
Stop. So why
80?
My thing is, why is that sex shouldn't be holding back what we are? That's all I'm trying to say. It shouldn't, right? Because if we gonna date, if we gonna be, sex shouldn't be that, like, because we could just fuck now, like, and now we've done that, and now
but
what?
Sexual
right?
tension builds, builds
that.
Anticipation. Sexual
and
tension
what?
Builds
for some shit that.
Nah, bro. Sexual tension builds right,
so anyway,
anticipation.
Let's
you know what I'm saying?
Didi said, imagine not having sex and everything is working in a relationship and then you have sex and it's trash.
That can happen.
It can. It very
That's
much
why
can.
I like to knock that shit out first so then we know
yeah,
the sex is
sometimes
trash.
I don't, but
if you're
I like
put in all that work and then it's going to not be what you want to do.
I like to know
so
that
sex
part.
Is the end all be all? Well,
no, that's
we,
not
this
what
whole
saying.
Conversation
No,
has
that's
changed.
Exactly what you're saying.
No, what I'm. No, sex is not.
I want
the fuck out of. Yes, it is.
No, that's not.
You're just saying everything could be amazing. A1 lit.
Mm-hmm.
You have sex is trash. You're like,
no,
I don't know.
No. What I'm trying
so
to
sex
say
is the end all be all.
No, what I'm trying to say is I don't like to. Put
it's a
so,
deal breaker.
No, what no. I'm trying to say is I don't like to put so much responsibility into sex. So I like to knock that out so that we can just go ahead and get to who we are.
So you just want to fucking get a nut out the way real quick.
Well, honestly, no, it's not in that way. But I like to just fuck to get that out of the way so that that's not the thing.
I just said that. That.
Nigga just said that.
But no, but you saying get a
Can
nut.
Not
I'm not
say
saying
that?
Get a
wait,
nut.
Wait, I'm bugging.
No, I'm not saying get a nut.
Okay, cool.
I'm not saying.
You literally just said the same thing Bobby said.
My point
word
is not
for word.
My point is not. My point is not to just bust a nut.
I want
to
listen properly. No, I want to listen properly. I want to listen properly. Same one time.
Once again, he mixed his liquors.
He had the Zaveca and the Bacardi.
That's light and dark. The Zaveca is dark.
Just do it. What I'm trying to say.
They about to throw a mile.
I'm not. I'm fine. I got my appendix.
Wait a minute.
Listen, what I'm trying to say is, in real life, you know, I like to just move past the conversation of sex.
Nadira said, don't make it a thing. Let it happen organically.
But that's kind of, but that's what I'm saying. I don't like to make it a thing. You meet somebody and there's always this part in the back of your brain. It's like, yo, but I want to have sex with you. I want to have sex with you. And my thing is, it takes over you meeting this person and seeing who you're dealing with and dealing with them.
So you are making it a thing.
No, it's already a thing, bro. Just because you got a dick and she got a pussy, my nigga, like, that's really what it is.
It's a vagina.
It's a thing.
Yeah. It is a vagina, okay? Don't violate. It's a vagina.
It's not a pussy.
It is a vagina.
Not a pussy.
It's a vagina. Vagina.
No pussies over.
No, it's a vagina.
No pussies
over. A pussy is a cat.
It's a cat too?
No, it's a vagina.
Well, maybe my phone.
It looked good to me.
don't do that.
Not on my phone.
All I'm saying
is. You got me nervous.
I like to move past the concept of sex so that you can actually get to meet the person that you're dealing with. A lot of times we put up
a lot of false things before
it's
you get
It's all
to,
because of sex.
Sex, yeah.
Bro, like, a lot of times you meet a person and it's like just sexual tension for months. Or days or weeks or whatever. And it's like, if you could just knock that shit out, now it's like, do I like you for real? I don't know. Because I've just been trying to fuck you for the past 3 weeks.
But once again, you can say that as a man. You enter. If you was a woman, you would not be saying that. You're not just going to be entered by everybody because it's just tension. It's tension in the room. Fuck everybody. Fuck them.
But if you actually get to know women, there are women that's kind of like, well, honestly, I was thinking the same shit.
Agreed.
I'm just saying, but what happens is guys typically don't talk to women like that. We typically don't have these type of conversations. I've had a lot of sex with women.
Sexual tension.
That was just kind of like, well, honestly, I want the fuck too. You just waited 3 weeks being all tensionous.
I mean, but I like sexual tension though. But I like sexual tension. It doesn't do anything but build anticipation and makes everything more.
But you know what it is? We from New York. So we value wordplay. Like, we value.
So the, like,
he
look,
from, for I don't
example,
know where the fuck he from.
We learned the art of deflection. Shout out to Who Shall Not Be Named for teaching us the art of deflection.
Bum ass nigga.
But deflection built sexual 54. Tension.
No, what Dame is trying to say, and the thing is, like, I think that the caveat here is that it has to be mutual.
Right.
Because if it's mute, because, like, I've had this situation before, and you guys probably have too. It's like. When you're talking, you could be talking for a little while, but neither one of you is really saying anything.
You're not saying shit, bro.
You're not saying.
You're like, yo, we're trying to fuck on the low.
That's some New York shit.
Y'all just not interesting.
No,
it's not that.
Well, it's not about not being interesting. It's like literally, you could go out, you could have a date, you have a good ass time, but literally everything that is being said is surface level.
There's nothing's
cutting any deeper because.
Y'all looking for a real relationship.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying.
Like, you're not going to write a whole dissertation on the first date. I get that. But at the same time, I haven't been in situations where it was just dry. Like, that feeling to me is foreign. It is.
I don't mean it's, what's it called? It's not
dry. It's not dry. It's just two motherfuckers trying to act like they ain't trying to fuck right now. Knowing that you are.
Oh, we want to fuck, but that doesn't mean we don't talk.
But this is what I'm trying to say.
But my conversation is still A1.
It's not elite. And then you talked about, that's what I say. We deviated from the topic. Yeah. Sorry. But my longest relationship was a date with a girl that I was like, yo, she's fucking horny right now. Like, and I'm horny, like, and I could just read that. We like, yeah, I love movies and goddamn the shit. And it was a great, and laughing, joke. God damn it. And seriously, was having a great date. And I was like, all right, listen. I'm fucking horny. We can go to this next bar and spend mad more money on more drinks. We can. I'm okay. This is day one. I'm with you.
I would never say that.
So what happened is.
Yeah, you from West Bubble.
Whatever the fuck. But that honesty, it took her by surprise. Because she was like, honestly, I don't even want to keep talking about. I'm horny. Nigga, it's been months.
I'm with Nadira. Tap, tap, tap. Like, is this thing on? Let it happen organically. Because that's not organic at all.
But it was organic.
That's
because
some
it
creepy
was,
force shit.
It was organic because it was literally what she was actually thinking. And she was like, I fuck with you for reading that. Versus us trying to play the Bacardi or Sivecca. It was like,
that's,
all right,
that's
we,
never
we
a
having
thing.
These dumbass conversations when honestly we both just horny. It's been a while. Like, I ain't been on a date in a minute. You cute, I'm cute. Like, what the fuck? Like, and that's really what it was.
You cute?
I'm cute as fuck. Relax. Hold on now.
Now you distinguished because you old.
I'm definitely distinguished.
Yo, what's the next topic?
Distinguishably
what's
cute. God damn it.
What's the next topic, bro? Nigga said you distinguished.
No, you're not cute. You distinguished. What
are you talking about? All right, man. Let's get this last
Yo,
one.
Yo, you
go,
are
man.
Distinguished.
So do we fuck with that girl or just A or B it? No, yeah.
With what?
The girl orange hair. Trash.
Like I said, to me, she was trying to get a husband.
Got you.
I think that was pretty dope.
She was
trying to be
she
ratchet.
Good shit?
I mean, she doesn't realize what she's saying, but I agree with some, not all.
Cute. I know you're the first time you're hearing of it.
If she's actually doing what Willa says, I fuck with it, but I think
she's doing it for the money part.
I don't really believe her, so no, I don't really fuck with her.
Okay, cool. Okay. I'm going to say I don't fuck with it because the premise of
what it
women,
was is for money.
The premise for money
it was me. Just for straight money.
I don't like that. And that's just a bad way to walk through life trying to get money from all the guys. All right. So let's end this one.
She wasn't distinguished.
Let's do it.
No justice.
Why you have to look like that one?
Bro, I'm not laughing, bro.
I know.
I'm not laughing. You ain't see how I look just now. You ain't see how I look. That's why.
He looked at Josh like, no justice.
That's why. My fault. This is a serious topic.
By the way, don't look me in my eye like that again.
What was that?
I'm going to do it again. I'm going to do it again.
I didn't know that shit was ridiculous.
I'm going to do it again.
Just read it as regular,
man,
bro.
Stop looking at me, bro. Like, you just read.
My fault.
Just read it for real.
Yo, out of three
no
officers,
justice for Breonna
out of the three
Taylor.
Three officers that we know dealing with the Breonna Taylor situation.
Yeah.
One of them got indicted today. On a D-class felony. A wanton endangerment charge, which doesn't even include Breonna Taylor's name.
Yeah.
Quite frankly, it included everyone whose house those bullets penetrated.
Yeah, next to
her house, instead of Breonna Taylor's. So it's fucking mind-boggling to me, but they can pay $12 million to the family for a wrongful death, but they can't
charge
anyone for the wrongful death. So what the fuck was the money for?
Because what I heard, those charges are pretty much like communities, like if...
1 to 5 years. I mean, like, even if they got charged the full amount.
No, the charge was you let your firearm off recklessly. Because it was an apartment building, the bullets could have went through a wall and hit anybody. So the six bullets that hit Breonna Taylor is null and void.
They're like, that's why we're charging you. See what happened? What could have happened, but it did. So instead of rectifying what actually happened, that's crazy.
I watched it live on CNN today.
Oh, you was watching it?
Yeah, I was watching it.
You was there for a minute.
It's funny because before the CNN had their whole coverage, and before the verdict or anything like that, they literally was on some like state of emergency was called in Kentucky, and
they were ready for that. They were ready for that 3 days ago. Here's the thing: 3 days ago, this is how I got an inkling that this shit was not gonna go good. It's 3 days ago. They all the Louisville police officers that were on vacation,
were taken
off of vacation.
Mm-hmm.
So like, which
oh,
to
the
me,
same thing that happened in New York.
Which means
they beefed up their security.
Yeah, which means that they had an inkling about what the hell was about to go down.
Which means they knew that they weren't going to be charged, and they were going to be charged for that D-class felony. Mm-hmm. I heard that's pretty much like what they give protesters here. For just protesting, which means
you're not getting 1 to 5 for protesting.
No, you're not getting a D-class.
No, at the most, they're saying like it can be. That's what I read real quick in somebody's post or whatever. But regardless of what, 1 to 5 years for shooting someone, for shooting someone.
But the issue before you even go there, the issue it wasn't even brought. That's not even a part of the charge.
No, I'm with you on that.
There is nothing about murder. Breonna Taylor or anything like that in the indictments.
Right. It's just about shooting, period.
You discharged your firearm in an apartment building.
Right.
And a plethora of things could have went wrong. So because of that, we have to charge you.
Damn.
But somebody got shot six times.
And they charged one person.
Somebody got shot 6 times, but we're not going to talk about that. They're going to talk about what could have happened. Because Tom, Dick, and Harry, who live in on all the apartments surrounding the apartment, could have got hit. So we have to charge you because they could have got shot.
Right.
But the individual who did get shot, we're not going to talk about
we're
that.
We're not going to bring it up.
But we're going to pay the family $12 million.
Right. That's what they were saying.
Does this sit right with anybody? That's like, let me know saying. I'm bugging.
No. But that's why the hashtag for her was say her name. Because this whole time, they never wanted to say her name. No one ever wanted to speak on
it's like what actually Voldemort. Happened.
Yeah. That's crazy to me.
I'm buying a shirt that says her. It says say her name and it says, like, it's screaming Breonna Taylor. So I'm gonna wear that shirt
because that's crazy.
Because that's real shit.
And wasn't she like a security guard or something? Am I tripping?
No, she's an EMT.
She's
EMT.
Okay,
my bad.
26 years old, sleeping in her house. And then what they said, because it was a no knock warrant, which is some bullshit.
That's what I wanted to get
like,
to.
Like, let me know if
I've never heard of a no knock warrant.
I've heard of it before. But let me know if this makes sense.
But that's when they know the case and they got
there's,
you.
There's a no knock warrant.
Yeah.
In a state that has a license to carry. Does that make sense?
No.
I can kick down your fucking door in the middle of the night. And there's a potential that you could have a licensed legal firearm in your house.
I would never. I live in Brooklyn, New York, and I wouldn't do that.
No, but what I'm saying is people outside of this, trust me, like the Second Amendment is big. People walk around with their firearms.
But I'm alluding to your point. We live in Brooklyn, and nobody would just kick nobody door in Brooklyn.
That's not my point. Listen to what I'm saying.
To the same shit.
That's what I'm saying. Look, you have something that literally goes against each other.
Yeah.
It's asinine.
Yeah.
No knock warrants, license to carry.
Which means that if everybody you kick can in, be strapped.
Exactly. You kick in anybody door in the middle of the night, they can grab their piece. What's up?
Yeah.
So now they say that they're warranted with shooting blindly because the boyfriend shot first. But you kicked his door in the middle of the night. You see how this shit don't make sense?
Right. So pretty much he acted within his legal rights.
He was defending his home. I don't know who the fuck y'all are.
He acted within his legal rights. Yeah. That's crazy.
So because of that happened, because he discharged his firearm first, what they're saying now is Breonna Taylor's death is kind of justified.
It's valid.
It's warranted. The cops were doing their job. Because
the lawyer who's defending when I was at your crib.
Talking to the mic.
Sorry. The lawyer who.
We've been doing this for years, bro.
Yeah. I don't know why he's forgotten about the mic.
The lawyer who was defending the officers stated that.
Ben Crump.
I don't.
Oh, wait. Sorry.
No. He was defending the family.
Sorry, other way. Sorry.
The lawyer who's defending the officers and the police department of Louisville stated that after further review and they reviewed everything, the police officer's right to defend firearm was that right because they were defending themselves. They said this. I never forget it. We were reviewing the topics and I was sitting on the couch and they said that out loud. It was on NBA TV, and they said that the lawyer stated that it was a big ass press conference, and he said that they had the right to pull their firearms and then discharge it and shoot it because of the fact that the gentleman shot.
Here's the thing,
and I found that to be completely.
But you knocked my door in the middle of the night. Right. I don't know who the fuck you are.
Here's my thing though.
It's asinine.
If you're gonna use, because like this is the argument that a lot of people were talking about, like they would potentially use if they were going to have the officers, you know, if the officers weren't going to get any real charges. And let's be real, none of these are. This is not a real charge
at all.
Not a real charge.
It's
at all.
Nothing.
Then my problem. Here's my thing.
It's a slap on the wrist.
You need to then the person who continued to execute the warrant. Because from my understanding is like they went into the wrong apartment. And they also
they didn't have the right people.
No, but apparently they already had the right people.
He was already locked up.
So as far as I'm concerned, this is a
This is
like more of a wrongful death.
But they already paid the $12 million.
Yeah. But here's the thing. I understand that they paid that, but I'm talking about for justice in my mind. How I see it. Whoever either neglectfully didn't realize that they were going to the wrong place or decided to continue, realized it was wrong, but still thought it was worth continuing with the warrant, that person needs to be in jail based on.
That's the whole police department. Yeah, yeah. That's all of them. They all. I mean, made
But there's somebody. It always comes down to some
who pulled that who made that decision.
Who gave the code red?
It's lit. Go.
That person needs to be charged.
But that
if you under the under their if they're gonna have that reasoning that the officers are quote unquote justified, then that person who made that call needs to be in jail. That's how I feel about it.
It's just infuriating.
Yeah, but somebody needs to go to jail.
we got a wanted, well, not wanted, wanton endangerment in the first degree charge. Mm. So you never know. He might get 1 to 5.
Yeah. Like that's
one of them out of the three.
So
everybody saying it.
They said it was 100.
He said, "Yo, if I'm dead, sleep."
But they said it was 194 days, 149 days, some shit like that. 190 something days from since when she passed. It was March 13th. It's now September 24th.
So okay, so then let me ask a progressive question. All right,
we got 2 minutes, y'all.
Do we ever believe that it will get better? Right, like we have 100% thousand proof that it's gonna always be the same. We are all black men. We have a young lady right here. It's a gentleman here. We can all leave this space tonight. Get shot by a cop.
Yep.
Period. It's life. It's America. Do we believe, do you believe that it'll get better?
No time soon.
Cause that's, I think that's the frustration.
To be honest.
Or what change, like what can we, like what do you.
To be honest, to be honest, and I hate to bring this up, and don't crucify me.
Talk about it.
But this is the reason why I was so pissed at y'all last week. Because when I was saying ways that it can get better, I was being called too radical. And sometimes.
Nah, nobody said that. We didn't say that. Nah, you just.
He literally told me I was being too radical.
I said the word radical here last week.
On everything you did.
Okay, well more
I
than
put
a,
it up.
Well, okay,
I will put it up.
Well, more
but what I'm saying
yeah,
is
saying more than an argument.
So, but what I'm trying to say, I'm trying to lead. When I say certain shit, it's for real. It's a real thing. Like sometimes you have to do radical shit for change to happen because we've been doing the same shit and nothing is happening.
I do agree.
Insanity is doing the same thing over and over and over again, expecting a different outcome. Mm-hmm. We've been doing the same shit over and over and over and over and over again, mm-hmm. expecting a different outcome. Guess what? We got to do something different.
Yeah,
because
over there
we just congregating and walking and marching and Black Lives Matter. That shit ain't working.
Right.
Them niggas, they done painted up the streets. We got Black Lives Matter driveway, Black Lives Matter lane, yeah, Avenue Boulevard.
None of that shit
you
matters.
Got Nancy Pelosi taking knees and fucking
dashiki,
kente cloths. You got niggas throwing up the Wakanda Forever. You got everything other than what we need, and that is change. So guess what we need to do? Change what we've been doing. Because status quo not working. Breonna Taylor dead.
Yep.
No justice. Run up in the crib, middle of the night, kick the door in, shoot down the hallway. They said there was a curtain or something. He didn't even know what he was shooting. He was just letting off.
It could have been babies, he let dogs.
Off 10 down. Shots. Shorty got hit 6 times.
That's crazy.
But guess what?
I don't even
no justice.
This shit
nothing.
So that's what I said. Do you think it'll bar? Do you think it'll get better?
I don't think it'll get better because we're not going to want it to get better. Because we're not going to do necessary thing. We're not going to do the necessary things to make it better. That's my answer.
Yeah. I feel like it will, but no time soon.
Okay. Well, what? I'll ask more. What do you think we can do? Like, what's something you think we can do? I'm just, and even if you don't know, it's cool to say I don't know.
At this point, I want to say being radical will fix it, but I don't even think being radical will fix it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I really don't even have an answer at this point. I want to believe that being radical, like Willa says, is the will fix it. Because if that fixes it, you know what? Fuck it. Let's blow some shit up. We were all in agreement with yo them burning buildings down when they were doing all of that. Because we were like, we're doing something. So I'm with that. Burn all the shit down if that's the case. Fuck it.
Build anew.
We'll build it over again because who did that? Mm-hmm. Didn't hit. I forgot what country did that. They burned their own crops just so that whatever. But.
Look at you knowing half history.
Half of it, right? But
we have no facts. But something like that was
something,
true.
Some shit like that happened.
They did that, whoever they were, at some point.
In this essence, but I honestly don't even know at this point if being radical will even fix it anymore. Because us doing that, all it's going to do is, all right, we're just going to let... Because if...
You don't know what it's going to do because it hasn't been done, Barry.
I understand that, but so I don't have faith in us being radical. Because I feel like, to be honest... to be honest, what they can say, and I saw a video the other day, and it was a KKK member. He said, honestly, all you got to do is just let them niggas get mad and let them do what the fuck they want to do for the moment. And then after that.
So have you given up hope?
I haven't given up hope. I just don't know what we can do. I haven't given up hope.
You don't got okay.
I just don't have it. I honestly don't have an answer, but I haven't given up hope.
Because to be honest, that's where I'm at. And I wasn't saying you was being too radical, but that was a different topic though. So speaking on this topic specifically,
it goes hand in hand with me, to be honest.
So then what do you?
I've been saying this since fucking the middle of quarantine. Literally, my rhetoric has been the same. I swear to God, I'm the most consistent with this. We have been doing the same shit for generations.
Yes, yeah, true.
Generations. Mm-hmm. It's not working. Do something different. That's it.
So what do you propose that we do now?
Blow the whole shit up.
Just fuck it all. This is over for everything?
Blow this shit up.
My mom told me from a baby, those who don't hear shall feel. That's that.
And I get
that's
it.
That's that. But guess what? We shall overcome.
That shit ain't working no more, man.
Yeah, wade in the water.
Yeah, I'm done.
Guess what? That's the same fucking songs we singing now.
Yeah.
Black Lives Matter. Do it? Does it? Does
it? Yo, bro, really? I told y'all that works.
It's the same shit.
A man.
And that's the most benign statement ever. Like, Black Lives Matter. It's not even like a...
I told y'all at my job, right?
Even broke down the whole Black Lives Matter movement.
I saw, bro, they have jewelry. Yeah. Black Lives Matter necklaces and fucking earrings and shit. Like,
I saw that.
It's a thing now. It's a mockery.
So that's what I'm saying. I get
Black
what
Lives Matter,
saying.
Cool. Throw some fake rhinestones on an earring and sell it to them. I bet you they buy it.
Right.
That's where we at now.
Mm. Bro, I told you that a old
Breonna Taylor done got, bro, they done changed laws for Shorty. Not to say Shorty, no disrespect. They didn't change laws for this woman. They done paid the family.
But they can't arrest
somebody. They done legislature has been, like, things have been happening. Executive orders have been passed. Everything's happened, but Shorty can't get justice. Mm-hmm. Which means what? Nothing fucking happened.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's just lip service. Give them something. They'll be fine. Give them a street. Paint Black Lives Matter on it. They'll be good.
They've given you everything except the justice.
And we cool with
it. I told you what the old head of my, the man was 100 years old coming to take this COVID test. And he heard us arguing about when they first were burning down all the buildings and everything. And everybody was like, yo, we shouldn't be doing that. And 100 years old, them niggas said, yo, how many times you going to get punched in your mouth before you finally punch somebody in the mouth back? Mm. And when he said that, everybody shut up because it's the truth, bro. Well, at some point, you got to say, you know what?
You mind if I answer your question?
Go ahead.
The only thing I was going to say is the only time where I feel like we've really made any gains is when that we have had violence against the money. What I mean by that is
boycotts.
Yeah. Violence against
bus
the money.
Really
you have to ask, like, when has America responded at all?
Money.
When you fuck the money up.
Because like,
that's because it's the biggest business in the world.
Because here's what you have to realize. Like, for example, like the Civil Rights Act, when it was passed, it happened passed 4 or 5 days after MLK died. There were riots
after.
Right. But there were riots for 4 or 5 days. And I think people incorrectly, you know, for as much as people try to say like, oh yeah, nonviolence or whatever,
right,
people don't realize that you had your nonviolent holy person killed for one.
Mm-hmm.
And then on top of that, there were 4 or 5 days of riots. When people look at the rioting and criticize it just the way that they do it now,
mm-hmm.
what they fail to realize is like, yeah, there was rioting. Yeah, there was quote unquote violence. But it wasn't so much violence against people that really outraged people. And this is my opinion. This is an opinion.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that people got outraged by people being killed. People got outraged because it was fucking up the economy.
Mm-hmm.
When you have people rioting, looting or whatever, which to me is not even a big fucking deal.
Right.
Because
everything's covered by insurance. What's it called? You're fucking up the economy. And in my opinion, the only time America responds is when you fuck up the money.
Yeah, because we're a big business.
If you want something radical that I think that we should do, try to find every way possible
to fuck
up the money. Don't buy nothing. Or even go further than that.
All right, last point.
Let's just say a group of people, you know, came together and bought 97 acres worth of land, and they had an opportunity to spend money only on that land and not with the country. You would be okay with that?
What? Wait, sorry. I was
Pretty much alluding to the topic from last week. 97 acres bought by black people.
I don't know why you're trying to I think you heard wrong what we were saying.
No one disagreed with you.
We really did not.
You have a room full of people telling you that we did not disagree with you.
The only thing I think we were trying to do was the method. And doing it. No, you can be radical, but you have to be intelligently radical. That's all I was trying to say.
Right. We're not spending money with them. We have our own.
And nobody said no. And we didn't disagree with that.
It's not that. But we also broke down how much of us coming together is important. And right, because when we say radical, and if you say burn it all down,
cool, burn it.
I'm down. But cool, I'm with you. I throw a fucking Molotov. Yay, fire, take a picture with it, right? Do what they did for the whatever. But my point is, what's our goal?
Oh, what's next?
What's next? And honestly, that's what we were trying to say to you last week. Buy the land.
I answered it last week.
Got you. But hold on. So buy the land, but you also have to protect your land.
I said that too.
Got you.
I said
but militia. You also have to.
He said, "Don't worry about the militia because they're not going to hit us that way. They're going to hit us with the."
I didn't say don't worry about the militia. I just said that's not the most important thing.
All I'm trying to say is, because we haven't. What we're up against is a system that has literally pocketed itself in every single aspect of everything that we're thinking, right?
Pretty much.
So it's like burn it down. They're ready for that. Police it. They're ready for that. You try to get some money from they're ready for that. You try to get they ready for that. Because they built this shit. So
guerrilla pimp brute force. That's one thing you cannot be ready for. I'm sorry, you can't. And I said that last time.
But how are you gonna do that with guerrilla pimp brute force with 13% of the population? How does that work?
You will be surprised.
If
you hone in and bunker in,
I'm not gonna lie.
I'm like, to what extent are you talking?
How many times have you heard of prisoners overtaking the prison?
But in real life, numbers don't matter.
It don't.
We didn't, even all the way from Bible stories or the story of the 300. It was 300. They killed thousands. Like fine.
They made a movie.
Haiti was like 3,000 people. Twenties of thousands of people died. Yes. They won. Mm-hmm. I'm with you.
Hold on. What I'm trying to say is, be more specific. What do you mean by guerrilla pimp brute force? Because I don't want
to
misunderstand.
It still has to be a plan. And it has to be something that people agree on.
And I think that's what Josh was alluding to.
I would like to answer that, but I can't.
Go ahead.
I'm not trying to disagree. I'm just trying to understand.
What I mean by guerrilla pimp brute force, I mean we're not asking no more. The same sentiment Tupac. I said this
Tupac,
last week.
Yeah,
bro,
yeah.
I promise you, I've been very consistent. We're not asking no more.
No, I feel you on that.
Guerrilla.
We don't disagree. I don't disagree. I'm not asking for anything.
I just want to know what's the plan. And that's the problem. But the thing is,
I mapped out a plethora of things that can be done last week.
And we didn't shoot down all of them. We just rebutted some. We didn't rebuttal all.
You were the outside force. You were the outside force. You was here last week.
All right, so this is what we going to do.
Rebuttal all of his
and be honest, please. Let me know if I'm wrong, please.
I think some of the larger points. Yes. And then there was another part where it was another point that after the show, it was agreed on, but I guess it wasn't articulated in a way that everybody could understand.
Okay, fair enough.
That's pretty good.
There was an agreement after the fact.
Yeah.
But during the show,
it came up. I get what you're saying. It wasn't articulated in the best way so we can all.
So that we could all understand. All right, cool. Fair enough. Fired up. Well, that's life. I mean, and that's what happens. But that's also
important.
Thank
you, Refugee Rich.
Shout out to Refugee Rich. We agreed with you, motherfucker.
No, he just said all the larger points you shot down. He just said that.
No, he did not just say that.
What you just said?
But at the end of the day,
radical change brings radical change.
Yo, the one thing that I've learned from, and I'll tell you this, and I promise you, I don't know if this will wrap it up. Maybe you have something else. The one thing I've learned from having this podcast with you gentlemen and you, sir, and building the Willow Wednesday family page and watching people argue with each other all day.
Dear.
I've learned that we literally just can't agree, or at least. Not that we can't agree, we can't agree what's next. We can't, like, Because we're so busy fighting over little, small intricacies of left and right and up and down that we can't just say, all right, can we all just agree that it's chicken today? It's like, well, I'm vegan. It's like, well, God damn it. Well, like, you know, come on.
Well, I kind of disagree.
Exactly.
No, but that's
and
not,
that's why it's that's, hard for us to
that's,
move.
That's not fair. That's my point. I'm gonna be real with you. That's not fair.
That's not fair.
That's not fair. That's really not fair. That's really not fair.
So now let's debate about.
No, but we all agree. We are all in agreement right now.
No, no, no.
But we all in agreement right now.
There's more agreement than there is disagreement. Let's
just be real. Yes, but when it comes to making a choice, let's burn it down. Let's elect the governor. Let's da-da-da-da-da. Let's. That's there's a disagreement, and I'm saying it starts from petty shit all the way to big shit, you guys. Like, seriously, like, there's pretty much nothing that can come out of my mouth that everyone's like, yeah, that's at least. It's not even that you have to agree with me. It's just that we can't decide
what to do.
That's my point.
To be honest, there's no walk of life, there's no era that's had dominance on this earth that didn't have dissension in the ranks.
Do you want to know what era that is?
Wait, Dame, relax.
It is an era.
But Dame, relax. There's never been a time where there was never dissension in the ranks. There's always dissension in the ranks. There's always conversation. There's always, but what about this? But guess what? The majority would move. And when the majority moves, everyone would move. So, and the people who are left behind, guess what? You just left behind.
So here's what happened.
Okay, but the majority or the herd mentality would move in a certain direction. Sure, there could be Tom in the back, like, but what we could try this better. Tom's voice ain't loud enough. So yeah, we can disagree on this podcast, but if there was a movement of the Million Man March, I'm pretty sure there's somebody like, well, I don't want to march today.
I mean, yeah, because if you think,
but guess what? They fucking did it.
I mean, like,
majority rules.
I mean, like, at the end of the day, I mean, there are plenty of people that didn't. I mean, for example, you have people that followed MLK, you have people that followed Malcolm X, you have people that followed Marcus Garvey, you have people that followed Medgar Evers. None of these dudes agreed 100% on everything, but you know what? They all moved.
There was a movement.
Yeah, shit happened because of them, because you know what? They at least agreed on some very basic common goals.
Yes.
On how to do it. You don't have to agree with everybody.
You don't have to.
So you want to know?
And you want to know why? You want to know why we're not going to agree? Because we're not a monolith.
What I'm saying right now. Everybody. What I'm saying right now. What I'm explaining to you guys right now. I'm not. What I'm explaining to you guys is, it's not that we need to be a monolith, because there's no such thing, right? Word. But the people that are in power at least agree on common goals. So white supremacy is the power. The one thing about people with working within white supremacy is they say, you know what? I fucking disagree with you, but we're white. I'm white. You're white. High five. We're going to do that. We're going to be the police. We're going to say, I can shoot up Breonna Taylor and then do what the fuck we do. And then all the black people will be mad. And you know what? It's fucked up, and fuck them. And why? Because you're white. I'm white. This is supremacy. We run this. Fuck them. Well, and that's it. No, and that's it. And we'll set up court systems that believe it, and we'll set up the news system to give you certain information, and we'll do this because we agree that we need to stay in power because we're white supremacists. But what black people are too busy is saying, well, I'm Caribbean and you're Jamaican, so that, you know, I'm American, you're East, so we can't, and that's what I'm saying. So we can't agree to burn shit down because we just never agree that that's one thing that we should all do. And that's the one thing that white supremacists fucking do. They say, well, we will stay in power. Why? Because I'm white. You're white. High five, motherfucker. We got it. Period.
That was a very, very good point.
Passionate.
Period. No, it ain't even that. But bro, that's the fucking problem. We can't even just discuss it and be cool.
Where's the thing?
We can't even just discuss it and be cool. They end of the day say, yo, white people hate each other, but they know they white.
That's a fact.
They'll tell you, he's a piece of shit. I hate this fucking. They always the lyrics are joking. I hate this fucking guy. This fucking guy's a piece of shit. But guess what? We're white. We win. We can't say that. I can't say you're black. I hate you. But let's win, bro.
Yeah, but
I'm dead ass, and I'm sorry that I'm so pat, but like that's what really bothers me about this, and I hate it because we're so divisive about such stupid shit, and that's why I said watching this page build, bro, and watch the conversations that all of these smart, intelligent people have week after week, and it's like all they do is bicker. I'm like, yo, this is crazy. Women come in and say things like, "Why don't black men just accept black women on topics?" And it's like, what? And then instead of just saying, well, because we ain't got it together and we should work on that, they just argue for days. My phone is like, and I'm like, what the fuck? And I'm like, wow, don't you understand that that's the problem? And so they be mad at me in my inbox. Like, damn, why you don't say nothing? Why you don't, nigga?
Listen, my
the inboxes.
We're like the referees. Like,
we like, relax.
I get messages from everybody.
It was just a joke.
I'm taking this motherfucker.
Hey, you know what I've done now to save
block
it?
Block him. And I'm like, no, that's the problem. You like, we all just can't disagree on some shit. And we're all fighting a common enemy. And we just can't agree that.
I be blaming Dame now. Whenever they come, I be like, yo, it's Dame's fault. They be like, why? I said, because it's just Dame's fault.
All right, man, let me get out of here, man.
No, that was a good point.
That's the shit that bothers me, y'all. I swear. I love this show, but that's the biggest thing that I've gained.
So, okay, so what's the basic thing we can agree on? Because you just had a whole fucking...
I did. It was a little long. I'm sorry.
I appreciate his passion. But you disagree. I do disagree.
Exactly.
I do disagree.
And that's right where it goes. I do. My thing is, I don't have a problem.
I feel what you're saying. I know it's coming from a good place. I actually really understand what you're trying to say. You're trying to act like there's no dissension among white people.
No, because that's what you just said.
You said there's no dissension among white people.
You're white, I'm white, we're right, we're white.
Yeah, and I'm just like, I know plenty of white people that are not.
No, but okay.
But we are living under white supremacy.
Dane pretty much the same, like, with all the differences they have, they can have one common thing. Like,
we're white,
let's get it.
And you know that. We just had a whole conversation about broke white people.
So whose
only thing in life is, I'm white, so I'm better than you, rich black man. I'm better than Diddy. I make $4 an hour.
So
I'm better than Diddy
because
I'm white.
Thing. So Dame, I'm asking you, let's wrap this up.
I'm saying, what can we agree on?
I'm asking you, bro. You had this whole thing just now, which was great. Right. I liked it. I agree.
Finish your breakfast. You had an N1 layup.
You feel me? Like, so what is one thing that you can point out in the black community? It's like, you know what? Let's agree there. Let's build on that.
Don't miss your free throw.
Can I answer or say what you're saying?
I don't know. I'm just gonna let you go.
The one thing that I can say that I think is a commonality within a white supremacy world is that black people can see, no matter what place you come from, is that we are treated a certain way. So what happens is, when a person literally has a plan, right? I'm not saying I got it, but sometimes you hear a plan.
So that's what you're saying.
What I'm saying is, instead of just condemn the person or break them down because their shoes is ugly or their shirts don't match or they're not Caribbean or their rice don't fit like the fucking, they macaroni ain't the same way as macaroni. Motherfucker, like, we all stupid shit, but I'm just not even saying get a plan. I'm saying listen, consider it, because we don't even consider it. We be like, who the fuck is this? He gay. So yeah, I don't listen to gay black people. You know, I could come through with a plan, but he's American, so he ain't Caribbean. So that means, what? But we don't even try. Like, we don't even listen. Okay. You had a plan the other week.
And they got shot.
And it got shot down by y'all. I don't think I was shooting it down, but I'll be honest. But let me finish. Mm-hmm. That's the problem.
Yeah.
That's what I'm trying to say.
I was there last week. That's why I shut the fuck up.
But that's what I'm trying to say.
Y'all got it.
I know. I know. Look at Barry Fitz. I know, right?
It is what it is.
Now he's the savior. We just didn't listen.
I was trying to lead y'all to the promised land.
You know what? Thank you for watching Willow Wednesday.
I saw the mountaintops.
Can we watch?
I came back with the scrolls. I came back with the scrolls and the plans. I had it all. Nobody was listening. I've been to the other side.
Plymouth Rock.
I seen
Plymouth Rock
ain't land on me. I landed on Plymouth Rock, and I came down the rock to tell y'all what's happening at the top of the rock.
Hey, real quick, thank you for watching Willow Wednesdays.
We see y'all next week, man.
Damn, listen to me. I came from the rock.
Mr. Officer J. Willa Damo, Alex Britney, man.
And what
Let's
they did
get
to
it
me.
In, man. Let's
what they did to me.
I got
to
pee,
mic,
man.
What they did to me
cut
last night?
Week.
They crucified me. I got crucified. I got hung. I'm Jesus. I came with y'all.
You cut his mic already.
Seems like every day another brother slain. While these crackers pulling triggers just to scratch their itch. Pounding pavement, sick of all this trained enslavement. Kill a nigga, that's just paid vacation. It's a message to my son, 20 years in the making. Just know that daddy left earth blazing. So when they approach you, saying get your hands high, put them shits up. That's when you switch up, and instead just put your fists up. You gotta ride for the cause, cause if not, you gon' find that your life was a loss. And it's hard, cause we just wanna love, why they love to denigrate us. You're a source of power, generation to generate us. Yeah, just be that light and baby shine on. And I promise to provide them tracks for you to grind on.
What do I tell my kids? If I want them to live like you live. Just like you live.
but she just don't understand. I vote for Obama and he never lent a hand. He beat Denzel Stroller taking pictures with his friends. While wars being waged by the descendants of the clans. Men, you really think that you free?
Do you?
Keep praying, G, it's gonna be more gone. It's crazy that we rather put stages than flame a torch. I'm usually with powers of cable, been out of sorts. Seen water on that table, some Kindle steps on that porch. And that same damn year, Reggie died up on the court. So, don't ask me if politics is a sport. Won't own no gun shops, no ships, and no ports. Don't be defeatists, just look how they defeat us. They keep the jail cell from the fetus sports. It's an amusement thing for a great plot scheme. And it's funny that they plan for the same damn scene.
Kill us, never forget we die.
Okay.
Never forget the fact you fail even when you try.
Yeah.
Systematically, everything designed to go to jail. Whether mumble, rap, or trap, we preaching them by the cell. And everybody.